straight up. Yeah, let's get the show. It is the All New Rollout Show. It's your boy Speed Dougie Doug in the building right here at MorrisMediaLive.com in your mouth. It is now time for... Yeah, we got a meeting after this, Ron. The nigga said, wait a minute. Just let it happen. I got words. We got words on this one. Here come. Let it happen. Here
listen
come.
To it.
Affirmation of the day. Come and talk to Speedy. He really wants to meet you, girl. He has an affirmation for you. Whoa, come and talk to Speedy. He has an affirmation for you. He wants to brighten up your day.
I sure do, baby. Shout out to my man named
Dwayne.
Killing it.
He has a mixed version. I need to download it.
Hey. Just let it happen. Mixing my shit. Is this it?
That's it.
Oh, okay. It is now time for affirmations with your boy Speed Dougie Doug. Just a little something you could tell someone. Oh, I guess not. We ain't got no camera. Light ain't on. Yeah.
She's fixing the camera, everybody.
We'll wait. I don't want to
she's
give
getting
my affirmation and my
they
light ain't on
you.
Me.
They can hear you.
No, they need to see me.
He needs to drop his bifocals.
I don't need to because I can actually see this one.
Allegedly.
and it's just something you could tell people as you go along in your life. I'm only responsible for what I say, not for what you understand.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. That's actually a good one.
I like that.
That's what I do. Ron, really? Just...
Why do you always look for affirmation from Ron?
Because we supposed to be, we homies. You supposed
you
to be
You mean
like,
confirmation.
I ain't say that shit.
I say affirmation.
Again, as you go through your life and someone says shit to you, you can always say, I'm only responsible for what I say, not for what you understand.
Hmm.
You like that?
I like that. Sound like everybody like that.
Ron, you just got yourself another week. You got one more week added on to your shit. It is your boy Speedy in the building.
I'm the poetess.
Nikki Pam.
Tangie Ambrose, heaven high.
Tangie, do me a really...
You're a little too happy right now.
Yeah,
you're a little too happy.
Your joy is a motherfucker right now, and the outfit is not helping at all.
I'm only responsible for what I wear, not for how you perceive
that's
it.
That's right.
Okay. Ooh, wasn't that good, Speedy? Wasn't that good? That was good.
How I perceive it? There ain't shit under that motherfucker.
Speedy said,
you look
God.
Marvelous.
Speedy said, perceive
Thank
it.
You
look absolutely fantastic.
Thank you.
Okay. That's going to be a great show today. It's going to be a fantastic show. So how have you been? How was your weekend?
Oh, my goodness. It was fantastic.
What did you do?
I watched.
Again, I'm with POTUS. Bring your energy level down.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. Let her have her energy.
A little too joyful
okay,
in this
yeah,
motherfucker.
Calm down.
Yeah, I need the energy. Go ahead.
Okay. I spent time with my babies.
Rock and Stone.
Yes. I watched. I have been watching the National Democratic Convention.
Uh-huh. Off the chain.
Yeah.
Michelle Obama should be. She should run for president right
she
now.
She should.
Yes, maybe next year. I mean, not maybe
the next
maybe never, because she's probably so ready.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
To get up out of that White House is not even.
I think's gonna happen with her. She's gonna be able to make money doing
speaking.
Oh yes.
Oh,
yes.
Sure.
Oh yes.
And she'll probably be able to do more now.
She should definitely write a book.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
I'd buy it.
I think from here, because her speech was so off the chain that Donald Trump didn't text not one thing. Mm-hmm. Normally he says something about whatever somebody does. He didn't send
a text
out
about
anything.
Well, apparently some people had a problem with her saying that the White House was built by slaves.
It was Rush Limbaugh. Whatever the fuck his
Rush
name is.
Limbaugh.
He'll be all right.
That he was saying that she needs to get over that. That, or as a people, we need to, fuck you, nigga. We know who built that motherfucking place.
Right.
We did.
Right.
Well,
not me.
I wouldn't have built it. Our people. And Pam wouldn't have did it. Maybe Ron would have put a C on the motherfucker somewhere. Poetess would have told him.
He would have painted it blue.
Yeah.
Blue carpet.
At least one blue room. But, oh, man, she destroyed. Yeah. Oh, my
she
God.
She said, when they go low, we go high.
Man.
Look, 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 look. Check this out. Just like me. Not hello, but heaven high.
You're reaching. You're reaching.
Okay.
I tried. So she stole that from you?
No. No.
And you know they were probably looking at her speech going, we got to find something. And nigga, she was so original. Oh, my God.
And she looked fabulous.
Yes. Yeah, I can't look at her like that.
Tanji, we have already a question for you in the chat room. From the chat room, Queen of Zamunda wants to know.
Hi, Queen of Zamunda.
Did her and Kente ever go out on a date?
Should I tell? He ain't here.
That's all right. That's all right.
Yeah, he ain't.
No.
Oh, okay.
Do you think we should?
Yes.
We thought y'all was.
Yeah.
Do you think we should?
We thought that's why he went home early from the show.
Oh, really? No, we didn't. But he's really nice, though. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You guys talk, though?
We have
text.
He might have a girlfriend or something. I don't want to
No, he don't have one.
Oh, yeah, we have text.
Oh, okay.
He's really nice, and it's interesting because he communicates in a way that, because I'm busy. Uh-huh. And he communicates in a way that didn't get on my nerves, and I actually found myself responding.
Oh, okay.
And I mean, I'd be like texting a lot back. I said, "Ooh, I had to apologize for typing
really?
So much." Yeah.
Yeah, it's always weird when the dude just get "How your day?" I just say "How your day?" and you do a whole paragraph. I'm like, "Nigga, bitch, I'm gonna put it into that. It's cool.
Right.
That's all you gonna get from me,
right?"
Cool, good day. Right. And then they'll go, how was your day? It was all
right. Right.
That's exactly all in my texts. It was all right.
It was
so
all right.
Y'all really get your text. So when a guy texts too much, what are they like? They hitting you too often?
Oh, you know what gets on my nerves?
What?
There's this one guy that texts me. I don't even know how he got my number, but he's always sending me pictures of himself.
Mm. Oh, that's enough. Ron.
Why would you do that, Ron?
Ron. I said, Ron.
Why would you do that?
Are you doing that?
It's too much. And it's the same smile. And his face, one picture, he would be handsome.
Mm-hmm.
But 50?
Right.
Maybe he don't want you to forget who he is.
You said what?
He don't want you to forget who he is.
Well, delete.
Oh!
Delete. Yeah, I already forgot.
You don't save them, huh?
Mm-mm.
Hilarious.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, that is kind of annoying when guys
do you
that.
Get genital pictures. That's...
Yeah, and then they like, okay, where's mine? I don't know.
Right. And the genital pictures.
You don't want to decide to send the shit. I didn't ask you.
Exactly.
Right.
They mess up with the genital pictures, too. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you why you shouldn't send genital pictures. Because, you know, the girl gets to know you. Kente say after 3 dates or whatever, she might like you a little bit. Mm-hmm. It won't matter so much. But if she doesn't know you and you send a picture and it's not pretty.
Ooh.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's
I've been
over.
Saying that. Thank you.
Yeah.
Really?
So if they have a beanie on it, it ain't cool.
No.
No.
No beanies
no.
on.
No. Okay. But if you know the guy and then he sends the picture and it's a strange color or it's, you know, doing something different. Because mm-hmm. they're really beautiful.
Yeah, right. They're art.
I've only seen one.
They're art.
They're art. Yes.
I've only seen one.
You're a liar.
Yes, well, yeah.
I've
you seen your kids. You seen.
Well, that's different.
Don't send the pictures.
You've been to a urinola, too.
No.
You never
looked over.
Man code. Man code.
Bullshit.
Ron, tell them. When brothers go, we don't look at nobody. We look forward. I don't give a fuck what happened on these sides. I don't see it. I remember I walked in and Jonathan. Mm-hmm. Jonathan then pulled his shit all the way to the ground. I said, hey. It was a bunch of dudes and one little white ass. I said, hey, man. What the fuck is you doing? He was like, Hundado, pull your shit up.
He didn't know better.
Nigga, his shit was at his knees.
That was the white side of him, I'm sure.
Well, it was the white side. Goddamn sure. And some said, going there, uh-huh. Nigga, I've been in the corner. I see a little tiny white ass. I said, pee pants.
Not a good look.
And I was caught off guard like a motherfucker, man.
That is freaking hysterical.
Man, I said, oh, shit. I said, my man, you got, he said, huh? I said, no, don't drop your shit to the floor. Mm-hmm. Go in the handicap room. Use the handicap bathroom, and you can do that.
Right.
They usually do. But when they do come.
But there is a code. There is an etiquette for.
Yeah, brothers, no. Just okay, same thing in the shower.
I'm never in there, so I don't know what's
etiquette. So we don't look to the side, to the left. Right. We don't hold no conversation. Everything is straight right here.
So if somebody says, what's up, man?
No, you don't speak. Don't talk to me.
So right now. We're in the urinal. We're there. I'm Bob.
Bam.
Okay.
Pam, you are.
Trey.
Okay, here we go.
And I step in. Bam.
What's up, man? I like those draws.
I'll beat your ass. Or in the corner of your eyes, you will catch a nigga doing Peter gazing. Nigga, hey. Some niggas get right in the urinal. Like, you see
get
a motherfucker.
Get up on it.
And then you got them niggas that come in and step back. Excuse me, dog. Yeah, all right, nigga, we get it. Like, shower, even as in high school.
That's
nigga,
funny.
I took showers at home. Mm. Don't get caught in the shower, nigga. Niggas, so anyway, on that play, hey, nigga, wait till we get to the field.
Don't talk about it.
No, we don't do that shit here.
Really?
At home, we deal with it.
Okay.
So, etiquette for men is we don't talk. Now, that's why they put a couch in y'all bathroom.
Yeah, because right. We can talk.
Yeah.
We can talk and pee. Hey, girl.
Look at your shoes. Those are cute.
No.
Those are my legs. Will you pass me some toilet paper?
In the stall?
Yes.
Nigga,
we can't see each other, though.
Right. In the men's bathroom, if it ain't no toilet paper, it ain't no toilet paper. I'm not finna go. Hey, Ron, peel me off some. It ain't no toilet paper. You don't know it ain't no toilet paper in there. I know it ain't. I look around and go, nigga, shit. And you take the shit that you put on the seat.
Right, I do that.
Yeah,
you roll that motherfucker a couple times. Yeah. Now, do y'all, when you do the seat, nigga, I put a pillow. Nigga, 95 sheets. It'd be two left in the thing.
And you know what I do too? I don't know if this is like a curse of me, but it's the first one always falls in.
Always.
Yes.
Okay, I thought that
was because you move too fast and the wind blowing, it goes, nigga.
And then sometimes I accidentally step. I'm like, oh, shit.
No, I put at least five down.
Yeah.
Then I take the toilet paper because in the crack, what happens in the men's bathroom, dudes always look through. Anybody in there? Nigga, you see me?
They look through like that.
Yeah. So you take the toilet paper, you wet the corners, put it up there. It's like a curtain. Ron, am I right?
Y'all don't do
that. Oh, okay.
You ain't never did that shit? Nigga,
Wait a minute. Who taught you that?
I just figured, nigga, you not finna stare at me on the who? Oh, sorry, bro. Because you always sitting there like this, and then y'all get straight up eye to eye. Hey, oh, nigga, shit. So as soon as I get in, I take the toilet paper and I roll off a nice little length.
Uh-huh.
Put a little spittle on both ends. It's like glue.
Heard
and then them two stick there.
That.
You do the bottom. Then when somebody walk by, they can't see through.
Right. Okay.
That is clever.
And always pull your feet back.
Oh,
because I don't really want you to know I'm in there. Because we go like this. When you leave, they look and see the shoe. Oh, that's the nigga that was shitting in the bathroom. That nigga got the blue sandals on. That nigga was shitting like a motherfucker in the sandals. So you always bring your feet back to you. Never know it was you. Because niggas always look up. Yeah, that nigga with the Jordans was shitting like a motherfucker in the bathroom.
True that, true that.
Hey, I'm just telling you the real. That's the code in the bathroom.
That's etiquette.
And then the other thing that we will do, when you see the dude come out the bathroom and just take a beeline without washing your hand,
everybody,
go like that.
Yeah.
Oh, let me wash my hand. Yeah, nigga.
Yeah.
Wash your motherfucking hand.
After you wash your hands, when you open the door, you use toilet paper so you don't have to touch the handle
shirt,
too, right?
Or shirt or something.
Man, and I, we ain't that. Nigga, if we got it after I wash my hands, it's probably on the door.
But check this out. You washed your hands, but maybe Bob didn't wash his hands. So then when you open the door to go out the bathroom, you touching Bob's nasty hand.
That's true.
Well, he done wiped his butt.
Men don't think that far ahead. We never think. If that was the case, nigga, why put the... It should be no doors.
Check this out. Any man that would think to pull out some toilet paper, put some spit on the end, and hang it up to keep anybody from peeking in would think to grab a little toilet paper.
I just don't want you looking at me. Oh. I don't give a fuck about my hands ain't clean. Please don't look at me.
Okay.
So now everybody can be using my look. I'm telling you that
shit
works.
Yeah, they said, but they're saying you're OCD in the chat room. Yeah.
No, but that's... I'm the only one to do that.
Yes.
I've never heard that.
Yes.
You don't mind people looking in at you.
But they don't be looking in. The door is closed.
Yes. No, it got a split right there.
Really split.
It don't completely close. So it got about this. It's about that much crack. And that much crack, you see me. I don't want you to know I'm even using the bathroom. Like, I can't use, like, if we dating,
yes,
I cannot use your bathroom.
No, really?
What if you're there for the weekend?
Right. That's what I was getting ready to say. What do you do for the weekend?
Denny's? What do you
I'll
do?
Wait till you go cook.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
And then
but you still use it.
But you don't know that.
Oh.
No, you in there cooking. By the time I get done, I just spray some incense. I then you take this is what you do. You spray or you take deodorant and you wipe it. You put it on the toilet paper. You run it across.
Uh-huh.
Roll it up. And that's like if you don't have incense. If you don't have an incense,
light
the end. You roll it up tight, it'll burn nice
Stop
and slow.
It.
And
I never thought of that.
I gotta try that.
Or you take cologne or spray and you spray it on the toilet paper, roll it up really tight, light the end of it, set that motherfucker right there, handling your business. When you come out, it smells like potpourri shit. Hey, man. Even if we're in a hotel and we fucking, I don't use the bathroom. I go downstairs and I'll be like, let me go see. I got to go to the front desk.
Yeah,
right
when
back.
You're like with a guy or a girl, whatever. And yeah, I definitely go downstairs if I have to do a number two. I'm not going to do it with him there.
Ain't going to do that.
Or hopefully he knocked out.
Oh, you
blow know
it
what?
Up.
You know what? Let me tell you. Before my mother, you know, she was like you. Don't use the bathroom around anybody, right? And before I met my children's father, I was like that. Mm. But he was like, fuck that. He'd come in and the door.
He would be in there,
you know, shaving while I would use
don't
the bathroom.
Come in.
And at first it was real uncomfortable.
I can't even.
But after you done pushed out babies,
I don't give a fuck. I can't even pee if you're in the bathroom. If you in the shower, I'll be back.
Really?
Can't do it.
No wonder why
my pee won't come out. He'd be like, nigga, she in the shower. Shit.
Really?
Can't do it.
No wonder it makes sense why you
can
like
shit
that.
In the shower, Ron?
Man, look here.
What do you do?
Yeah, I can shit anywhere. It don't matter.
Well, you a crip. That's different. You niggas shit on the fly.
Right.
Girl, that's,
I can't do it.
If it's somebody new, though, I have to admit,
yeah,
I have been like let's say Kente and I went out.
Mm-hmm.
And then we were, I don't know, at his house or something. And I had to use the bathroom and I had to really go. Mm-hmm. I'd be in there running water. And now I know I'll put some deodorant on some toilet paper.
Yeah.
Roll it up.
And roll it up.
Yeah, I don't know where you're going to get your lighter from that fast.
You
gotta
be
like
poetic
and smoke weed all the time.
No.
And you have a lighter on you. But carry a lighter.
Carry me a
roll
lighter.
Roll it up nice and tight.
Yeah.
Light the end, it's going to slow, but, you know, blow it out, it'll slow burn.
Where do I put it to burn?
Oh, I put it
in the
no, okay, so where the sink is,
yeah.
I just set it right there so the ash is going to sink.
Smell like burnt toilet paper?
No, because you put the deodorant on it.
Yeah. Or perfume, right?
Or perfume.
That's what I'm going to do the next time.
And trust, that's if you don't have an incense. This is where, you know, some shit I learned when I was in jail. But don't matter.
It sounds like jail stuff.
Hey,
I like that, Speedy. I know.
Actually
should market that. Speedy's incense.
And don't forget your curtain.
Oh, and my curtain.
Hang your curtain.
I don't think I'm going to do the curtain. All right, that's a bit much.
Try it.
Well, I must admit, sometimes I'll put my purse there.
Me too.
So, you know,
men
then they
purse.
Can't. Yeah, y'all don't have purse. But I had never heard of
but
that.
But I can't believe y'all asked, bitch, I like your shoes. In the bathroom?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-mm. I wish a nigga would. And them Jordans, nigga! Talk to me, motherfucker.
But we have more freedom because I can say, oh, Pam, you look beautiful. Girl, I love what you're wearing.
Right.
Look at your little figure. Everything all perfect. You can't say that.
Right.
But that's what niggas say. Yeah. Look at your figure. I wish a motherfucker would.
Yeah.
What about look at your gut?
First of all, it's going away, as you can tell. I played six games.
I got the white accent.
Nigga, Ron.
Okay.
I normally don't play more than three games. I played six games last night. This morning, I said, nigga, I rolled to the ground.
Six games?
I rolled out of the bed, hit the ground, and just kind of slid my way up. I said, I can't do this shit. Nigga, I'm not, nigga.
What were you playing, basketball?
Yes. I still think I have
or volleyball.
No, ooh, nigga. No. It, but it's just, I always feel like, and I had a great six games. I was really nice, no really fucked up passes, or I didn't look my age last night.
That's how old men get hurt, playing basketball.
Mm-hmm. No, I don't never, I'm not going to extend and dive for the ball.
Okay, good.
I ain't going to play no hella defense. I'm going to be like, help. I'm going to do all that shit.
Good. And do you stretch before?
No.
You got to stretch
before. No. Here's something I learned.
Tell me.
When you stretch in the beginning is when you have problems later on.
Really?
Because those muscles are used to being stretched. If you don't stretch at all, you might pull a muscle every blue moon. Like, it may happen to me, but I've only maybe pulled my hamstring twice in my life.
So wait a minute.
I've never heard that.
Wait a minute. So
you don't play if you
stretch regularly,
you start off, then you have to keep doing it.
You mean as a child or each game?
I'm just saying if that's what you did when you started playing football, basketball, then you have to keep doing it.
Oh, but you never stretched.
Never did. I hated stretching. Yeah.
So your muscles would be like, what the heck is going on?
No.
If you stretched.
If I stretched, yeah.
Okay.
Now I might do something to loosen my back up, but no, I don't, nigga. I ain't no bendable buddy. I don't think dudes should be. Ain't no way. You shouldn't know how to take your leg. No dude's leg should go behind his
yoga.
Neck.
No
dudes don't do yoga.
Do you do yoga?
He said yoga.
Do you stretch?
Thank you, Ron.
I stretch. Bro.
But you don't
stretch.
Do no. You don't put your leg behind your head.
Can you touch your toes?
You better not. Don't answer that.
That's
answer
good.
There's nothing wrong with that. That is
speedy.
So.
Why would
stretching
a dude,
is good for you.
I didn't
so
say nothing
yoga.
Wrong with stretch.
And so is yoga.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. No dude should be able to do. What's that number five Pilates
hit?
Downward
Russell
dog.
Downward.
No, dude. I don't want to see a dude ever do a downward dog.
Well, Russell Simmons.
And it's an ancient.
Let's go. Let's start naming them. Let's go.
Ancient art form.
No, you said Russell Simmons.
Keep going.
Flag football.
Flag football too.
Come on.
Kobe, the Lakers. Didn't they all do yoga?
I don't know.
The Lakers. Pick one of them.
There's nothing wrong with yoga. I'm not going to agree with you on that one.
You don't have to. It's my book.
Oh, right. What's your quote? You forgot?
Mm-hmm.
You don't even forgot.
Okay. What quote?
What is it, Tangie?
He said it is.
Take your foot off.
Basically, you said you didn't. I don't know. It doesn't matter. But it went with your motivational statement
your
gave. Too late. Moment gone. Ping.
You talking about that statement?
That one.
Okay, yeah.
That one. It's your book.
I'm only responsible for what I say, not for what you understand.
Yes, thank you.
I did, though.
You like that?
Thank you.
That was a great one.
That was a good one.
Just say it was good, Portis. Usually you roll with me on this shit. Do you pick and choose when you like me?
Yeah, I agree with you on it.
Okay, well, just stay with me then, nigga.
Because people misunderstand all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody has their own perception.
Especially through text messaging. Oh, my God.
Oh, yes.
I think that's the worst way
to communicate.
My niece, Miracle,
have long conversations.
Miracle only wants to text. I said, Miracle, the conversation could be misinterpreted when you interpreted when you only text. She's like, well, I just like to text. I said, but Miracle, just call me. She texts every single day these long ass fucking things about my mom.
I only like to call if it's a conversation that needs to be had. But if it's just something brief, a little note or whatever, then fine.
But I think that's part of the problem. We've become a world that don't even want people that don't even want to talk to each other. A text message is supposed to come on,
it's
call
fine
me.
With me.
I hear you. I go 50-50. You know, sometimes when you're like, say you're talking to a dude or whatever, and he just only wants to text, that annoys me. But then if he calls me too much, I get annoyed. So I don't know.
I'm in the car, and my wife, she calls me a lot. Whatever.
Nigga.
And Pam goes, nigga. So y'all just going to talk every day?
Wow,
I said all day.
No, you
we
said
We had left
every
the
day.
Studio. We
oh
only
my
got
God,
the
Pam, that's his wife.
No, and I mean, she literally, because I have to turn the radio down, is always a song
yeah,
she
yeah.
likes.
I'm like,
and
you got to turn down the radio?
She over there having asthma like.
Pam as the work wife. Oh, wait, Speedy.
What?
So I talked to Mom yesterday, and I go, oh, yeah, that was funny when you called in and said, you know, I do that at home. Mm-hmm. Mom was like, you do.
You do.
And I said, really, Mom? She goes, yeah, you do. You have to, when you are staying with other people, you have to deal with that. She got on me about it. I didn't realize it did it.
because it's so
you.
Natural.
That's just you, right?
And when I explained that to my wife, I said she lives by herself. There's nobody walking around going to the kitchen 6-7 times. They just don't do it.
Oh my God.
Well, then, too, I figure the reason why you were used to everybody sleeping upon each other and stuff in a room because you have 8 kids. And that's how you get down at your house. But the women POTUS and normal people, we don't.
We're not up going through the kitchen rattling pans.
Wait a minute. Becca, what happened?
Okay, so we go to Palm Springs and Speedy.
We're sharing a house.
Yes, and we're thinking it's just for the radio crew, but right. No. Here comes Speedy with the 2 extra folks and, you know.
Rock with his straggling stranger from a party.
Yeah, he bought a
bit. That was the episode.
And
right
then, so I'm just like, okay, we all sleeping on each other damn near. Some people share.
So right when I come in, I saw a POTUS on the couch. I said, God damn. I just started walking. I said, shh. and my group came in. So anyway, the bitch says,
if you wear a white pants, you get it in the ass.
And I know, what? I said, we probably got 2 times to come by. And we were in the room chilling. Michelle said, I got to get something. I said, what you got to get? I'll go. And when it went bad, I heard POTUS go, so this is going to be the last time you get something, right?
That was only after the 3rd
Michelle
time.
Said, what's wrong with POTUS? I said, hey, she's single.
Michelle should know me by now.
Mm-mm.
Right.
Nobody knows you.
Oh, well.
We know you by now because we've been with you for years.
It Michelle has too. She's been around about 4 years
yeah,
now.
At least.
So anyway, this one. So y'all is going to talk every day?
Oh, wow.
No, I said all day. Literally from the house.
But Pam.
Let me finish the story. From the time we leave my house, okay, he picks me up. They've talked another 3 times about the badass kids. Then I got to listen because he turns on the radio. If he leave the radio up,
Speedy,
I don't give a fuck.
That's so sweet.
I don't want to hear the shit, honestly.
Aww, so
I'm like, love you.
Yeah.
I'm like, these niggas, can I listen to my song?
And she only does it when so I go. So they go, I love you. And all I hear is, really? Like, hey, what's up? Y'all gonna talk every day?
All day. And then we left the studio yesterday. This nigga, I mean, swear, I was going to my little Ramona's or whatever. And there was another 3 calls from here to Ramona's, which is about, 5 blocks? I was like, really? Can I listen to my song? But see, here's the thing. Those conversations need to be had at the house.
Or he needs a headset so he can switch it from the car phone to his headset so
exactly.
You can still
so I can
be.
Because
now you in the car acting like you're not listening.
Right, but I'm listening.
You know, but you're listening.
Right.
So when you had him in, y'all didn't talk a lot.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
I'm asking.
I'm saying I'm not rude enough to turn down the music and make me have to listen to your conversation. That's the point.
When you're riding down the road with somebody, Pam, Speedy. Uh-oh.
When you call your doctor.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I need 6 pills for that. No. Speedy, can you turn that down, please? Oh, shit. Oh. So I need the blue one, I need the green one, and I might need the white one.
I have to re-up.
Who orders pills on the phone? Who does that? You don't even know what they taste like. You're like, I want 6 blue ones, 2 red ones. And the bitch taking the order like, okay, anything else, Pamela?
Hilarious.
Oh, my knee hurt. Let me have a black one. I'm like, what the fuck?
Hilarious.
And you're always on the phone.
With a doctor.
With a doctor.
With a doctor. That's true.
And does she turn down the music?
No.
So you have to hear.
I don't.
Pam.
I don't.
You turn the shit down in my car.
Mine is a couple of minute conversation. Like,
Ron,
shit is 15, 20 minutes of y'all arguing
back in the
over
day, street racist.
Michelle. I mean.
When the girl get in the car, if she turn your radio down, you don't pick that bitch up no more. Am I right or wrong?
I would never do that.
Am I right or wrong?
I don't do
street
that.
Racing days, if you got in my car and turn my radio up or down, you don't ride my car no more.
You cut.
Yeah, I agree. You know, but remember how we said when we're in the car and our song comes on and we're like at the destination we're going to go, we're going to sit and finish listening to the song, correct?
But I'm on the phone.
I'm like,
if I don't answer the phone, if I don't answer that phone and she know, you, when did she call me?
As soon as you leave my house, pretty much. Yeah.
You don't mind a guy conversation with you like that? I just got a text.
Yeah.
Do you hold conversations like that
in front of people?
Not if I'm in the car, I take it off my car phone and put it on my headset.
That's,
if there are other people
see,
in
there's
the car,
an etiquette to that.
So then they can keep listening to music and I can have a private conversation. I only use my car phone when I'm by myself.
Right,
man on the bus.
I quit. Wait. Oh, man.
I swear to God.
These niggas will not shut the fuck up on the bus.
It's the conversations people have on the bus and on their cell phone.
Loud.
Loud.
And loud. Yeah.
Super loud. Like, really? Like,
you don't know how loud. Like, you don't even know you could be that loud. But when you hear other people like, so the motherfucker said what?
Yeah.
Oh, bitch ass nigga.
All on the bus.
And you was like,
every single person on the bus could hear your conversation.
And they don't give a fuck.
They don't care. It's like they're by themselves.
Man. And they loud as fuck. Go ahead.
It's a little easier on the bus, I would imagine, because it's a lot of people there. But when you're in the car.
No, but when you're on the bus and you are loud, like, you the only one. Everybody's quiet after
that. Yeah, do that.
She was like, yeah, you're a poor ass fucking loser.
Oh, shit. Well, here's the thing. You can sit right there. Was she standing by you at the time?
She was sitting like across from me, and but Speedy, I got to use your trick.
What?
I'm texting. Hold on. Let me text it to you.
Yeah. Oh, man. Shit. I never noticed it until someone's around me how loud they are. And I want to go, please, sir, you're a little loud. It's white people here.
Yeah.
You're a little loud. Yeah. But black, we just be like, so the nigga said what? Well, shoot the nigga then. In the police station? Like, Ron, stop. He's going to jail.
Right.
But otherwise, your weekend was good, though, baby girl?
Oh, yes, it was. I worked out, too, Speedy.
You think?
I did. Mm-hmm. I did.
Are you the girl to walk in and take the shit off the mannequin?
No, I am far from that. I have babies. Mm-mm. When I go shopping for clothes, I get depressed because I'm trying on these clothes and I'm like, damn, nothing look good.
Wear a zero.
I don't wear zero.
Okay.
You have a banging body, Tangie.
Yes, thank you.
You really
thank
do.
Thank you. Y'all, thank you.
See, a woman could say that too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You
dude,
can't say that.
Dude can never go, run. Hey, nigga, you
got a bang.
You working out, my nigga. Nigga, socked in the chin.
What?
Bing. Oh, my bad, mama. See, your jeans fit nice, my nigga.
Wait, you can't say working out, my nigga?
All I can say is your shoes is fly.
You can say your shoes is
That's
fly.
That's it.
Or you done fucked a gang of bitches.
Or you fucked a gang of
bitches.
Wow. Like, if you ask me, is he cute? Oh, that nigga fucked a gang of bitches. Then that's the only way I know.
That's the measuring stick.
That's measuring. Or he a hard sell.
Do you fuck a gang of bitches?
I have. Oh.
But I can never tell him he looked nice in what he got on.
Why? No. Why? You so you're saying a brother can't compliment?
No.
Why?
No, I don't even know why we going there. There's no way two dudes go, nigga, that shit look good on you.
Really?
No. You only thing you can say, them shoes is fly.
Tangie, what do you think about that? Do you think a brother should compliment?
Yes. Yes.
You would date that brother. You would date a dude that went, damn, that nigga look good.
No. Not you said it like that.
That's what it sounded like to me.
Not he said it like that.
What about, nice suit?
Yes.
Nice
suit. You can say that's a nice suit, but you can't say it looked good on him. You cannot. Okay. No dude can go, oh, man, that suit look good as fuck on you, my nigga.
Oh, God.
You can't do
it's
it.
Not like that.
There's no manly way of doing it.
Yeah, okay.
You can't even if I'm a thug-ass nigga, hey, nigga, your shit sagging nice as a motherfucker, cuz. You going to get the shit slapped out of you.
Right.
All you can say is them Jordans. I'm going to get them. It's nice. Where you get them at? Boom. That's,
them is nice. Okay.
Them is nice. Them where you get nice. Them? I can't say the jeans. What I'm going to do? Them jeans fit good. Like, I
compliment him on his haircut, his beard,
I slap shit
his
out
skin.
Of you. No. It's nigga. No, your complexion is banging, my nigga. You can't
your
do it.
Your hairline is banging, my nigga. No.
No. What is wrong? Ron, come on, man.
I'm with you.
Okay.
That's so unfair, though.
That's what it's supposed to be. You have a son. His name is Rock.
Yeah, he won't say it either.
That's how old is he now?
He's 11.
Oh, him and Brooklyn, same age.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Yeah. So he know. Even my son, Brooklyn, though.
He knows. He knows because he's around his father. But what about the little boy that's not around his father that, you know.
That's around y'all 24/7.
Yeah.
Then he's giving compliments. Mm. His shorts look good on him.
Mm-mm.
Hysterical.
I like his split toes. So great. No, it shouldn't happen.
It was a lot of dudes with split toes in Palm Springs.
I don't know what's up with that shit.
It was.
It doesn't mean they're gay. The only thing that defines you as gay is if you have a homosexual relationship, a physical penetration. I never said it had to do with anything with being gay.
What I said was man code.
It was sissy stickish, remember?
No dude should have on split toe sandals. It just, that ain't a look for you.
I know plenty of dudes who wear sexy split toe sandals, though. Oh, but wait. Yesterday, I go hiking. I go hiking yesterday, and there is a man running up the hill with a stroller with two babies in it. In flip-flops, split toes.
Was it Jesus? Was it Jesus or Jesus?
Wow. I swear I wanted to get my camera.
You should have.
And take a picture of dude and be like.
He was definitely white.
He was white.
Yeah, he was white. I think he was trying to.
But I'm like, why would he run up the hill?
He's trying to get rid of the kids.
With split toes.
He's trying to get
rid of the kids. It's hard to run in split toes.
Wow.
Especially push a baby buggy.
But right. I don't know if that's.
And y'all what? He went. Did he get up to the top?
Yeah, he was gone. He
In my mind, when you said that, I saw this tall black man, long locks, muscular. He's got the babies. He's got on these sexy kind of ragged flip-flops running up the hill. I was like,
oh. I'm looking like.
Nice.
Where this nigga at? Why y'all pick the same dude? He got locks.
Well, you know, remember my baby daddy had him when we got together.
Right. He got to be glistening at least. At least glistening.
Gotta be glistening. Shining.
She would have liked Zion.
Oh, yeah.
She would have liked Zion.
Yeah.
Some nigga showed up to the
party. Hi, Zion.
Yeah, whatever. Nigga's in shape. So what? Anybody could be in shape.
But, you know, now that I'm older, he doesn't have to be in shape. He just has to be healthy.
So a little stomach?
I like a little stomach. I like a thick man I can hold and rub his little Buddha belly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, big old thighs.
I don't want you to do that, though. Yeah.
You don't want your Buddha belly rubbed.
No. If I'm on top and you rub, no. I'll be like,
Oh, no, you don't do it during those moments.
I don't want you doing while the game on either. That's not a good look. That's a little self-conscious right there. It'd be like, hey, boo. Bitch. You don't want us rubbing your stomach when it's...
I don't mind rubbing my stomach.
Well, you...
Yeah, I don't mind.
Okay, Pam.
You don't like somebody rubbing your...
It feel weird.
Because you're self-conscious about it. That's why.
Well,
what about your tits?
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh. I didn't say that. Speedy, I didn't say that.
You laughing so motherfucking hard.
Speedy, embrace your gut.
And tits.
Speedy, embrace all of you.
Yes, embrace you.
Yeah.
I'm actually losing.
Somebody loves you, Speedy.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly the way you are. You're a beautiful woman. And y'all talk on the phone all the time.
All day, except between 11 and 2.
Exactly.
But you know what? The body is just like the penis pictures. I mean, I fall in love with the man. I love his body.
I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to get the penis picture in the body.
You remember we were talking about don't send the penis picture before.
So you want a gut shot.
I don't want any pictures. I want to get to know you. I want to talk to you. I want you to talk to me. I want us to listen to each other. I want to see if we vibe.
Well, you could send me one. I'm just...
Yeah, Pam likes dick pictures.
You could send me one.
Buddy. Don't send me one until I like you, because if it ain't cute, don't have that hook, it's going to be like...
Hook? I
mean, yeah.
Oh.
The hook.
I shouldn't talk about that in case there's somebody out there who doesn't have that hook.
Sorry about the arrow. Okay. Anyway.
Yeah.
So you like a hook?
I do.
Hook to the left, hook to the right.
Well, not, you know, it's like it goes up and then it's room. Hook.
Hilarious.
Okay. Heaven high.
Kind of hard to say that after describing a dick. But Pam, hopefully you're going to get a man this year, right? Because you seem to be more concerned. Why do you say hopefully?
Because
there's a lot of dudes online that come in the chat room that are always concerned about.
Yeah, I noticed that. Yeah, I don't get that.
And some like you. And she every time she get a text from him, this nigga keep texting me. Delete.
They got to sneak up on her.
You got to open up, Pam.
I don't want nobody from my past, I learned, and nobody from Facebook. I'm good.
So, Pam,
mm-hmm.
What is it? that you want?
Loyal.
Funny.
Like I said, he ain't got to be, you know.
No. Don't tell me what you don't want.
I'm not talking about physically.
Tell me what you want. Loyal. Funny.
He has to be decent. I mean, have employed.
Employed.
And, you know, and a family.
Loyal, funny, employed, and have a family?
And about, you know, a family.
About
man.
Family. Mm-hmm.
No kids.
Okay, that's not hard.
Kid. I don't mind. At my age, I kind of, you know, but yeah, I don't mind. I don't mind kids. As long as it's not like a 1-year-old. I mean, right. You know what I'm saying? Because most likely they got baby mama issues.
But a 1-year-old or younger, or let's say one, maybe 1 to 5, you can work with that. When they're 7, 11, and 12, they ain't looking at you as a mom. They got attitude. I seem to me that would be
no. I'm saying
a
one or
sell.
Younger. I'm saying they're probably.
But when they're one, their mama is somewhere nearby, probably still trying to get in.
Oh, absolutely.
More than likely, she's not.
Why do y'all think that?
Because it's usually true.
Oh, come
true.
On, Speedy. How many of your baby mamas did you fuck up?
Wow.
Until?
What the in the fuck is going on here?
You gonna ask me after some
you,
shit?
You've had babies with women, and the child would be one, and you would be through with the woman, or the woman would be through
yes.
with you.
He's a lie. It's the way he said it. Yeah.
Okay, back
well,
to
I guess that could happen.
Right.
Back to your list. At the end of the
those
day.
Those 4 or 5 things.
Those 4 or 5 things. Mm-hmm. So if you get 2 of those things.
I'm good.
We can hear y'all.
Yeah, I'm good.
So if you loyal, get 2 of those, you're
funny.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Let's go for all 4 of them.
I'm really going for loyalty at this point because, oof.
So with all these guys coming at you,
somebody,
how come?
Somebody get the gate for us, please.
How come you haven't? I mean, I don't know. At least one of them had to be right. loyal.
Oh no, that's
really?
Been the biggest problem.
Really,
the biggest problem. Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you know that they're not loyal before you commit to them? Because once you
I
commit,
don't.
They might
hand
say,
it, "Hand that to Ron."
You know.
Well, it's because basically they, you know, come across one way and then something will happen to make me go, oh shit, you know, you're not who you perceive, you know, who you show me you are. So when you show me who you are, I totally believe you.
Oh, well, that's okay. I'm with you on that. All right.
Yeah.
So I think you're single because you're not being more
but Speedy,
open-minded.
I've always been in a relationship. This is what you don't get. This is this one time I'm not for, you know, a while and, you know, in by good reason, trust me. You know, I was just fucking with somebody a little while ago. I mean, it's not like I'm never
well,
in a relationship.
Really
well, no, he did because we had history. But I'm just saying, it's just this is just a time where I'm not.
But there's
saying
a lot
I have
of guys who like you.
I know, but they come through Facebook.
So, but they might be
I've
a nice
been
guy.
There, done that. Not
but they, what if they're a nice guy?
They would have to. Really,
hers came through Facebook.
That's true, but
and
but,
she came up.
Yes, she did come up. And you did.
We'll see. I just feel like it's too soon for to.
Well, I mean, okay, we won't say.
Anything,
we'll just
so
say
far,
he's a nice
so
guy.
Good.
In the moment, we'll stay in the moment. You having fun in the moment?
Yes.
That's nice.
Yeah, and stay.
And
in
what
the
I've learned in dealing with my past relationships that we as women have to always adjust our expectations.
Yes.
There's a difference between dating and there's a difference between boyfriend and girlfriend, mm-hmm. and so we have to adjust our expectations. According to that, I think sometimes when we sleep with a guy, our expectations are way up here.
Yeah, we get all caught up.
If it's not, I mean, the least we expect is respect and to be treated right.
Well,
that's that's across the board.
Yes.
But in terms of certain things that men are supposed to do at stages in our relationships, we have to keep our expectations right. Because if they're not, we're going to be emotional. We're going to be jamming. We're going to be arguing with this guy because we have these expectations. But when we learn to get to know somebody and enjoy the time, especially in the early stages, and keep our eyes open, I think it works out better.
But I think
so
once, as a guy, back in the day, when I would hit, bitch, you pretty much belong to me.
But you're still out hitting other chicks,
that's
right?
That's not what I'm talking. That's not what I said.
But do you act like that towards her? Do you treat
do
her
you,
like...
Are you instantly in a relationship when you
pretty much, like,
somebody?
In other words, if she said, hey, I need to get here, then I'm going to take her. If we ain't fucked, you can't ask me for certain shit.
Right.
You can't say, hey, my mom is over here and I'm trying to get there. Oh, well, you still trying to get there.
Right.
So I hit. When I hit, then, you know, I do what I need to do.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yeah, I'm on the
That's team. If you like her after you hit. I mean, just because the fact you hit. I mean, you had a lot of one-night stands. Let's keep it real.
A lot.
You know, so not all of them you belong to, correct?
Mm-hmm.
He had kids with all of them.
Till I get back to that town. Hey, I'm in town. We're doing the show. You know,
we have a meme of...
God damn, nigga, I just got on the show.
Speedy doing yoga.
Oh, no.
Let me put this up right now for our audience to see.
I don't do yoga. That's not going to happen. This is ridiculous.
Oh, wait, I'll try to get the whole picture in. There we go.
Thank you, Ron.
Yeah. And then we have another picture from our fans of a guy looking under the bathroom stall.
Hysterical, Speedy.
Going, Speedy.
Hey.
Shout out to Chuck Farmer and Aaron Glass.
Look at his eyes.
Chuck be
with
waiting
the
to come up with a meme. Nigga, what they say today.
Right. Downward doggy dog.
Nigga. Oh, why, why they got to meme me?
Because you were the one that was opposed to it.
I don't do so. You don't mind a man that does yoga?
No.
Poetess?
Mm-mm.
Pam?
No.
I learned my lesson.
You can't say you say you don't want to date a man that does yoga.
I learned my lesson with
flag. Why?
Flag football was. He was a bit much.
Don't base it on him.
Got
oh,
to.
My goodness. You're going to rule out a whole slew of healthy, vibrant men.
Right.
Hey. Me and Ron don't do the shit.
But y'all are healthy, vibrant, too.
Well, they're vibrant. Maybe not healthy.
I mean, I just don't think we should rule out anybody for...
When you're single, Pam. Mm.
Well, yeah. When
you're
single.
Everybody should be open to date.
Like to say the men on Facebook, Pam. What if all the men said, I don't want to date no woman I meet on Facebook.
I have a few friends that have met guys on Facebook that has worked out.
Yeah, well, for me, it hasn't. So, and then I've,
but you're
and
picking
most of
the
my
wrong dude.
No, Speedy, I've been in long-term relationships.
Pam, maybe
5 years.
Maybe it has nothing to do with Facebook or yoga. Maybe you have to check yourself out.
It's a joke. Really.
No, and
but no.
Shout out to Mirrors.
No, I have always been in long-term relationships. It's not that. Like I said, I lived with the one dude for 8 years. The next one was 5. The next one was 3. And, you know, it's not like I'm not always in relationships. It's just something when I'm in the relationship.
Maybe it's time for you to just. Just be into
Can
yourself.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
That's
this is a
I'm
good
saying.
Time for you to be in love with yourself.
Absolutely.
So you can figure out what you need. The next one that comes
you guys
out.
Are missing the whole point.
Let me finish my point.
Fuck your point.
Oh, boy.
Jesus. Cut it off.
So angry.
No, what I'm saying during the relationship.
A little.
don't hit us. Shit.
Okay. Well, do we have some Ralph Tresvant?
No,
yes,
what I was going to say during the relationships, especially the long term ones, there was things in the relationship that I did not want to deal with. And I've been engaged 3 times.
But
I mean,
that's
I've been.
Not what
did you know
I'm
that at the beginning
about?
Of the relationship?
No.
Or you found out later.
Yeah,
I'm saying. I said, why not open yourself up to meet other people? We're not
I
saying.
Have. What are you talking about?
You said
about?
You won't do the people. Somebody on the internet.
I've done that a couple of times.
Okay, so that means the whole internet is fucked up.
maybe
you picked the wrong motherfuckers. How about that?
Maybe. But I mean, hey.
The right one just got to slip in. That's all.
No pun intended.
No pun intended.
Absolutely.
You get it.
That's it.
But, I mean, Pam, because you're a great person. Well, as long as they're going to ask you to go work out. Because you ain't going to work out or camping. You ain't going to do that shit. Anything has to do with anything, reaching for shit? No, I'm not reaching for that, nigga. But.
The right man can
you
make
just,
you do
it. I think you have just had to open
but it
your,
seems like you're more concerned about it than me.
Yeah, because I want to hear some story.
you like when I have my
I
want
to be able to tell a nigga something. Hey, nigga, you know what she like?
Well, you know,
like, you know
I tell you stuff, but everything can't be discussed on the radio. That's simple as that.
Oh, all right, Speedy.
Mm-hmm. I guess we'll move on now.
Yeah, okay.
All right, it's getting late. we'll take a quick break.
Yeah,
we got a lot of guests in the building, so we'll make sure we get them on. It is the all-new rollout show right here at Morris Media. Speed Doggy Dog on the mic. Wills is still over here, one of the best
Woo-hoo!
DJs in the
at
city.
At DJ Ron C7.
Yeah, so if you need a DJ for your kid's birthday party, he can do it. Or somebody died, he can do that one too. He can play a song like If You Don't Know Me By Now.
Oh, yeah.
Guess you ain't going to never know me. But Ron C in the building, take him off.
You my right hand. My go-to told me everything about you. That's a bold move. I know that you're out here and there's things you gotta go through.
Yeah, we are back. It is the all-new Rollout Show right here at Morris Media. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Doug, in the building. It's now time for affirmations with your boy, Speed Doggy Doug. Go ahead, Ronnie. Yeah, he pre-ejaculated.
Yeah, he did kind of pre-cum on that.
Yeah, Ronnie, it's all wet and sticky now.
Can you put your mic down a little
bit? Mine?
Yeah.
Turn that up, please. Or I can turn it myself.
You need it up louder for yourself.
Speedy!
Come and talk to Speedy. He really wants to meet you, girl.
He really wants to know
for you. Oh, come and talk to Speedy. He has an affirmation for you. He wants to brighten up your day.
That's what'll brighten up your day. Yeah. It is now time for just a little affirmation with your boy Speed Doggy Dog. Just a little something to get you through, make you feel a little better about yourself sometimes. Yeah. What? Here go. Whatever you want to do, do it. There's only so many tomorrows.
That's true.
I don't need y'all to validate my shit.
Yes, you do. Because if poets don't validate it, then you think it's whack.
No, I don't give a fuck.
I think
someone's taking the things that I say and they're applying it to their life.
I'm applying them to mine. I agree.
Thank you. You only have so many.
Yeah,
tomorrow.
I mean, I totally agree with that.
Yeah. So whatever you want to do, do it.
Mm-hmm.
Don't put it off to tomorrow because we don't, you know, like my mom. Yeah, tomorrow ain't here for you. Shit. The Lord said you might not be here.
Let's take a call right quick. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
And why you call?
Hey, sweeties. Tantizzi.
Hey, Tantizzi, what it do?
What happened to the parenting tips?
Here it comes. I have one for you.
Okay, thank you.
Really, Tantizzi?
Hey.
Hi, Pam. Hi, baby.
Did you see that picture I sent you in your inbox?
Yes, that is my baby.
Funny?
It was so cute. That is my baby.
Is that her son? You didn't show us?
It's a picture of a Pomeranian.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And you know what? And I saw when you said, oh, I wanted to see the Pomeranian. You know, I forgot to lift his fat ass up so you could see him. But I'll send you a picture.
All righty. Okay. Talk to you guys later.
Bye. All right. Thank you, Tante. I will jump on there. It is your boy Speedy in the building.
Bam. I'm the poet.
Nikki Pam.
Tangi Ambrose, heaven high.
Too much energy. Damn, Tangi.
And in the building with
in the building
is rapper YZ.
YZ right. In the building.
Yeah. All the way from, well, originally from Jersey, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And YZ's actually been out for a while, and for the true hip-hop fans, they may have heard of him. And now he is actually back with a new project, and he's here with us today. On the Rollout Show. Welcome,
yeah.
YZ.
Welcome.
Thank you, brother. All right. Hand class. We normally have a little.
Thank you for having me.
We got a lot going on over there.
There you go.
There we go.
There's a lot more people in the studio. Thank y'all for talking. A lot of beautiful people here. All right.
Yeah. Hey.
Talk about the new album and what have you, other stuff you've done has been what?
Actually, a bunch of shit. Well,
you cuss like a motherfucker.
Yeah, we cuss. And we talked about shit and you can.
Yeah, you
can.
Okay, cool. Well, actually, why am I here or what am I doing? Period.
Period.
Both. Same as always, buying real estate in Atlanta.
Oh, shit.
Right now. Atlanta, okay.
Well, I've been doing
that's under
like
the bus. You know,
years.
I got money.
Right.
I don't know about that.
No, we don't know about that.
I wasn't throwing anybody.
Yeah, too late now.
Yeah. Right. I'm successful, you motherfuckers.
I'm buying sneakers. That's it, man.
No.
Yeah, well, you know why you are where you are.
Okay. Oh, shit.
You know, it's funny. You're going to have me going somewhere else.
It's all good.
Hey, Poetess, this is political or what?
No.
Be yourself. Do you.
Oh, okay. Because I'm about to throw somebody under. You talking about sneakers and shit.
No,
you should be throwing like Jordan under the bus.
Why? Well, that part
he
of
did
it.
Come out this week.
Yeah, he did.
But that's some bullshit.
You think probably he
go ahead,
got,
bro,
you think
talk
he got
about
pressure.
It, please.
Speak on it.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, I mean, Jordan is so fake. Like, I mean, on some real shit. Like, people been reaching out to him for a long, long time. I met the brother a couple of times. He was phony then. He phony now. Mm. And he's still on some phony shit. And to be honest with you, when he made that statement about all of us as a whole, fuck him.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just how I feel. And I tell him to his fucking face, fuck him. If you can hear me now, fuck you.
No.
He said
yeah,
it,
you
dude.
Know, the other rapper, Chameleonaire, came out also.
Yeah, that shit was crazy.
Last, what was about a week or two ago, he came out with a video about how he his experience meeting Michael Jordan that the dude was like, get the fuck out of my face. Just like hella rude to him.
Yeah, he was. A funny thing is, I'm going to tell you, when I met Jordan, Jordan was actually cool to me. Mm-hmm. But most of the dudes that I know that is rude to other folks, they're always cool to me. Which is not cool. Like, I figured you should be cool on the whole. Yeah. And one thing you don't do is you don't disrespect people who put you somewhere. Like, I mean, here it is. When Jordan came out and told everybody, he was like, look, I don't make shoes for the hood. I don't make I'm like thinking, nigga, fuck you.
Because we're at the end of the day,
and still the only ones buying. Yeah. To be honest with you, we talking about boycotting shit.
Like, has he ever come out like to speak when kids have died over
ever.
Shoes? Like, nothing. Has he ever Thank made
you.
A comment?
I got you. See, I didn't really want to go here.
No, go there, man. Please.
I just don't. I don't like phony people. And then now, all of a sudden, you know, it's Nike said, hey, you know, we need to think about this. You know, blah 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 blah. And now it's all of a sudden, I ain't going to do any more shoes for the hood. Nigga, you ain't never been doing shoes for the hood. You already said that.
Yeah. I don't think that was, I don't know.
What did he say?
Right. I was thinking of something.
He said, I'm not putting out any more Jordans. But I thought the last Jordan came out about 4 years,
no,
3 years ago.
No, that part I heard was not a true statement.
Okay, so what was the true statement?
We're going to find out. Bam.
The statement about him not putting any shoes out until we unite was on a satire site.
Okay, that's
so you got to watch that. Oh.
And you have to understand it too. The All-Star Game is coming to North Carolina.
Actually, no, it's not. Not anymore.
They
changed.
They changed it.
Yeah,
because I know they had some laws they were supposed to change
because the gays peeing in the bathroom. Yeah, or something. Yeah, exactly.
Must have changed those laws. Oh,
so they don't know where it's going to be. They're actually talking about having it in Atlanta. They're talking about a few different places, but Charlotte will not be getting it this year.
Wow, that's a lot. Of money they're gonna miss out on.
Mm-hmm. That's a big thing right now.
And it's dope that you are looking at the political side of it. I just feel like I don't know what it's gonna take black folks to actually do that on a regular. Why is it that you have to wait for somebody black to die? Or is something somebody has to say something very fucked up for you to go, you know what, I need to stand up.
To be honest with you, on some real shit, I disagree that black people are always saying always saying we can never. I think that's propaganda. I think that's a bunch of bullshit. Mm-hmm. To be honest with you, I think black people, if they just understood that we spend more money than anybody in the world,
yes,
that we could put our money in our own neighborhoods, our own banks, that we should have stayed separate, that Martin Luther King fucked up, and that, you know, and he realized that on his deathbed that he fucked up, mm-hmm. and that we could really just create and control our own shit without them, without the help of them. You know, the bottom line is, you know, we are powerful and we need to understand that.
Now, I'll go with you halfway.
Oh, you can't.
I'm going to have to go halfway. No,
you can talk about systematically, let's go to the schools. We can start right there. 5-year-old, we got any children in here? Anybody got children?
Got kids.
If you're sending your kids to a school, a mm-hmm. public school, mm-hmm. what is that public school teaching them? That they are subpar, that they are less than, right from the door.
Well.
So it begins at home.
It has to begin at home. But
what I'll say, we are very powerful money-wise. We don't know how strong we are, even because we don't take that opportunity to go, you know what? If this person says that, then stop buying that.
So you're going to stop buying Jordans?
I don't buy Jordans.
Yeah, thank Nikes. You. Neither do I.
Nikes. But I have them, and I won't buy them no more. But I don't think we can separate ourselves from them. Because at the end of the day, you're going to need other people to move forward.
I think you misunderstand what I'm saying. I'm not saying that we need to not do business. I'm not saying that mm-hmm. we don't need to figure out a way to unite and do what we have to do. Mm-hmm. Chinese do it. They're here. Yeah. The Jewish people do it.
Yeah.
They have whole societies right here in this country.
Persians do it.
In this city.
And they coexist. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is where we fucked up is we want to be under and alike. And I'm like, look, at the end of the day, be you. Be proud of who you are.
But I think we were so suppressed where we want to be liked. We wanted to be liked, not knowing that being liked.
That wasn't always the case. If you go back to the 50s. Mm-hmm. You go back to Black Wall Street. You go back to where we had our own, where we were actually doing our own. And then the 60s came, and then you got Lyndon B. Johnson and your boy, God bless the dead, Martin Luther King, saying, hey, we need to figure out a way to do this while we're getting bashed in the head in Alabama. And that was some bullshit. At the end of the day, what we should have said right then, because can you imagine how powerful we would be right now if we were teaching our own.
Okay.
If we were, you know, doing what we do, just take the Jews for an example and say, hey, what makes the Jews so powerful? The only thing that makes them powerful is that they unite their funds. I know Jews that hate each other, but they unite their funds.
Yeah.
They unite their funds.
And I must say, when I was in New York, and there's a part of New York, okay, right where Jay-Z grew up, and the other side of where he grew up.
Okay.
Is where all the, and you go to that part of town. And it's just them.
Well,
it's
like
literally just them. and you see them, and it's families on families on families by 9,000 minivans. I ain't never seen so many fucking minivans in my life.
We've had that a few times in history, though, and they got burned down, right?
Yes, in Philly and Watts.
But I think that all that we did, you know, and you're talking about Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, he and Malcolm X were both coming to the same point when they died. But I think all that we did back then was the best that we could do back then. Because that's what we did.
We know better, too.
Because I think if we could have done better, we would have done better. And I also think that that's done. So it doesn't really help to argue about that. But
I don't argue that point. I agree with you there. We need to move on.
Yeah, because right now, tell me what we should be doing right now.
Doing exactly what we're doing.
So when I leave here, what do you want me, Tangie Ambrose, to go do?
Go take $100 and put it into a black bank.
That's what I like. Talk about some of that stuff. That's
now
good.
How many black banks are there?
There's actually one down the street over here on One United on Crenshaw.
There you go. What is it, Citizens?
I like that.
And there's been a couple of rappers or celebrities who have been leading that cause. I think, where was it?
I'm just scared about
last week, I think it was, when they said everybody put some money in the black bank.
But that's not new, though.
That was in Philly.
Oh, no, it's not.
Yeah, it's not new. The only thing that's new about it is, like you said, somebody got to get punched in the face or killed, and then somebody saying, hey, but we've been actually trying to get people to push money towards black banks for years.
I'm just scared if I put my money in there, I won't.
Why?
Oh, wow.
See, that's
the misconception.
I'm joking.
Oh. But
then
see, but
then you're joking.
But see, why you're joking, though? That's the truth, though. Most people
have
been led to believe
fear.
That, yo,
they
if you put your
fear.
Money in a black bank. Well, the federal government is federal government. If they want to stop your money today, and they do it all the time.
So your money's in a black
white
bank.
Banks you can put
only,
in
I don't even fuck with banks like that. And if I'm going to fuck with a bank, it has to be a black bank because I don't trust white people.
In the building right now, rapper YZ kicking that real. So black, that's one start we could do. Pull your money from here, put it, find a black bank to put
and
it
in. And dialogue, period.
Okay, at all times.
Dialogue. Now, let me ask you this. You got 10 kids in front of you. You said the schools are messing up. They're 10 kids. What would you tell them?
Well, I would talk to their parents, not to them.
I'm a parent. Tell me what you want me to know.
It'd be nice to know that you can homeschool your children until you feel like you're getting justice in the school system.
You want me to stay home and teach my kids?
And then how am I going to?
Well, think about it. Okay, all right. Let's think about this. Okay, hold on for a second. So he said him stay home. To be honest with you, you should want to do that, but let's just say you don't want to do that. Let's say you don't. Because at the end of the day, if we don't want to teach our kids, then at the end, they're at the mercy of the court at that point, right?
Yeah, but I teach my kids and they go to school.
Well, that's kind of like an oxymoron. If you teach your kids one thing and they go to school to learn something else and they spend most of their time in the school, who do you think is really teaching them? If they spend
most of their time in the school. They're in school from 8.
I'm just using this as an example.
And I'm telling you, then with mommy.
Most kids today spend most of their time right here.
Most of their time on the computer.
Most kids don't even go out to they don't want to work out no more. They don't want to go play at the park no more. They want to sit right here.
That's a lot of them.
Some parents just want them to be in a room and don't fuck with me. Where I'm not like that. If they even touch the phone or touch the computer, now go read a book.
Okay.
Now, after you read a book, let's go outside and play.
I agree with you, but you want to say that all parents, not just because a lot of times when we speak, they think that we're only talking about black parents. Truth is, most parents don't give a shit about their kids.
They sure don't.
Of all races.
Y'all, I'm sorry. And it might be just because my kids right now are 8 and 11, and I'm in a wonderful school district with black people and Armenian people and Russian people and Chinese people, and these parents, oh my God, the stuff that we do for and with our kids, and they go to a charter school that's excellent. I'm
at that school. Charter schools, that's a, that school, but now so you're talking about something good.
I went to that school more when my son was in kindergarten than my mother went to school my whole 12 years of high school.
That's true.
And the parents do care. So now, tell me what you want us to do.
You want us to homeschool them, and what else? Well, I think homeschooling is a start.
Okay.
Actually thinking that being a part of your child's education, depending on whether you send them to a public school or a charter school, to be involved. To be involved. A lot of times we don't understand that just leaving a child to this beast right here, mm-hmm. they're subject to anything and
so
everything.
Wait a minute. So instead of the phone,
take it away.
You want me to homeschool them. You want me to take the phone away, take the computer away.
What if the parent is not? Just monitor.
Yeah, just monitor.
I mean, it's people listening. It's people listening. And you have suggestions. I just want you to be clear.
Well, I could just tell you what I did with my children.
Love that.
At the end of the day, there was no, during the week, there was no TV. There was no phone. There was none of that.
No TV?
See, but to me, why is TV so important, though?
Well, for me,
we got a segment.
Honestly, Paulus, what is it about TV? Why is TV so important?
Well, for me, it's important because I make my living on TV, and that's how I take care of my kids.
Well, see, what I'm talking about from another perspective,
let me give you another perspective. For me, Tangi, for me, when I'm on television, regardless as to what I'm saying, I'm spreading love.
Well,
I'm spreading light.
Well, okay.
That's what I'm doing. I'm making people forget what's going on in their lives and enjoy themselves for a few moments, which is very important.
Maybe people need to be watching you then, right?
Yeah, they...
they smile.
Or things more like you, because right? We're not doing that. Basically, what we're... And I say we as a whole. And
yes.
I don't mean just black people. I mean just we as a whole are allowing...
The
phone and the television to raise our children,
right,
instead of
right.
us raising.
Because we have become a lazy society,
yeah,
that wants everything. Just shut up, go in your room, play your phone, play your computer, just leave me alone. And a lot of parents get caught up like that. And then they go, I don't know why my son is doing this shit because you're not involved in his life.
That's right. Be involved. Well, you asked me what. You know,
so what did
involved.
You do? You said I did this with my kids?
The What'd bottom line is I listen. I listen to my children. I pay attention to them. I watch what they do. If they're going somewhere, I need to know.
Yes.
At the end of the day, I don't just say you can
run
go out
streets.
The door whenever you choose to. Yeah. My daughter's 18 years old, about to go to college. And if she leaves my house, I need to know where you're going,
mm-hmm,
because at the end of the day, if something happens out there, you know, I want to know where you're at.
Okay, I got it. So homeschool, listen to them. Take away the TV. Take away the computer.
I'm not saying completely take away the TV.
I'm saying monitor them.
Monitor the TV. Watch Tangi on TV, but all those other people,
Nah, see, I see y'all make it light about things, but at the end of the day, to be honest with you, I think it's very serious. I think the very fact that we've decided to, you know, distance ourselves from children. Do you realize that kids these days, most of their conversations, they don't even talk to each other. It's all text.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you'll find it. And then I heard my wife say, hey, you know, I'm watching the door. I'm like, what you doing? She's like, I'm texting Glenda. I'm like, why are you texting Glenda? Why can't you just call her?
They only communicate through text.
That's not a good thing.
Yeah.
I mean, because what you're doing is you're teaching them to be distant. You're teaching them to now not, you want them to be social, but they're less social in a more social environment. That don't even make any sense.
Like the weirdest thing now, I was in New York and I come down into the lobby. We're doing a show there. And I look in the lobby and every single person is looking at their phone. Mm-hmm. And I mean, you could have ran through their neck and nobody would have never noticed.
Yeah.
And New York is standoff in it anyway. They don't really, that's not a New York thing to hold conversations. But now with this phone thing, you literally, there's no way to actually go down the street and meet somebody because they're right here because they don't want to talk to you. You got a headphone and they're looking at you like, please don't talk to me. Please don't talk to me. I'm doing something. and you're looking at them like, yo, what about some conversation? How's your day going?
We're learning to not be able to communicate.
I do that with my son. I just showed him Brooklyn that when you shake somebody's hand, you shake their hand, you grip, you look them in the eye, and say your fucking name.
That's right.
Don't hold your head down and go, no, motherfucker, I gave you a great name.
Most people
roll
can't look you in the eye because they don't do it anymore.
So, yeah,
that's a good thing, too, though. That's a good thing, too. And when you tell them to look the person in the eye, you tell them why you need to look, which is some of what you said, because, son, you are powerful.
Oh, you are.
Yes, okay, go ahead. What were you
going to say? Well, I was just going to add on to what you're saying. And one thing, I went to go see... who was it? Sullivan. Jasmine Sullivan.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, that's Speedy's girl.
Oh, she's
crush.
So fine.
It's funny. I'd never seen her.
She's so fine.
But when she came back, I wanted to see her. So I go to this show. Everybody in the audience got their phone out.
Yeah. Not even listening to
the
concert.
Thinking, you can't even enjoy the moment for the phone. Yeah. The woman is right there, and you're looking at your monitor.
I'm guilty of that.
Why do you do that? Like that, I feel like everybody wants to capture the moment.
Yeah,
but
instead of being, you're already in the moment.
Yeah, you're missing it. Yeah, you're missing the moment.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's true.
I love it. So, YZ, you got an album coming out, or what do you have?
I actually have an album out called Muad'Dib.
Am I showing my age when I said album?
Yes, but that's okay.
No, people still make albums.
Yeah, that's full length of albums. That's what it is.
Dang, whose ring is
that?
That
was me, his. And I'm sorry.
Man Code, let me write that one down.
Bugs Bunny.
Yeah, Bugs Bunny.
You know, the project that I'm working on right now.
I can't wait to hear what your music is about.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
Well, it's funny. It's funny. You don't know any of my music at all.
You don't know any of my TV shows.
But the reason that I say that is I bet you he could play a song of mine right now and you'd be like, oh,
I bet you he
could
play one of my, my shows.
And then you'd be like, oh, shit. Oh, that's you?
Well, I'm excited after all you just said because I know it's going to be proactive.
Well,
I can play it for my baby boy and he's going to feel good about himself.
You could.
And it's going to balance out anything that he's not getting at their school that I'm not telling them or his daddy's not telling.
He'll learn how to
if they could balance more on the radio this. Okay. I mean, at the end of the day, there was a time where, you know, there was a nice balance on the radio. Nowadays, outside of internet radio, it's very hard to find that in commercial radio anymore, unless you're listening to white stations. Somebody said something real weird to me, and it made me go and see. They said, every time I listen to a black station, right, all the music is negative.
That is Bugs Bunny.
I thought I put it on hold. But anyway, all the music is negative.
Mm-hmm.
All of rap is about... this is... What the fuck,
Paul?
I'm doing an interview. Please don't call me. I'll hit you back.
You know how to put the bottom side...
Yeah, please. I thought I did it.
Talk to Paul.
There we go.
So listen...
you good.
What I was saying is he's probably calling in to tell me to tell you something, probably.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, because that's how he is. He follows me.
Come on, Paul.
Text Paul.
Anyway, so what?
Tell him to call that number.
Yeah, call 323-293-3375 if you want to talk to us. But anyway, what were we saying?
You were saying that people were saying all these black radio stations play negative stuff. See, Paul, I was listening.
Yeah, yeah. They were saying that every time they listen to black radio, especially when it comes to hip hop, that everything was negative.
True.
Everything. So they got disgusted and figured they'd turn to a white station and see if they heard anything remotely close to what they were listening to on black stations. And they said it was the total opposite. They said that everything was positive. Even the announcers talked very friendly. It was like night and day. So
Heaven
I'm like thinking
high.
What I'm just saying is just more systematic issues that we're having to deal with it.
Me neither.
I never looked
but
at it.
You listen to a black radio station, it's either R. Kelly doing his thing or somebody like that. All the R&B kind of sounds the same. And I'm not knocking it. I'm not saying knocking it. There's a place for everything.
Everybody sounds like Chris Brown. Let's just keep it real. Everyone sounds like Chris Brown.
Chris Brown sounds like somebody else, too. But I don't want to get into that. Because I like Chris Brown. Listen, I'm not dissing anybody. I'm not dissing any rappers. I'm not dissing any R&B. Do what you do. I'm talking to radio stations, the owners, the people who are the program directors, really, nowadays, that pay slaves just like basketball players. Just like, you know, the slaves are getting paid more, so they do what they got to do.
Yeah.
I get it. But it's sad when you can turn on black radio and all you're talking about is black death. when you can turn on a white station and you're talking about white life. Mm. That's really bad.
I'm going to have to just do that survey. I'm going to do that today. Mm-hmm.
And people like in the Bay Area, for example, Cameo was starting to go left and play a lot of, you know, the corporate music on the same top 10 songs or whatever. But the community came out and protested so heavily on that radio station that they now, because originally KML, that's all they played was local artists.
I remember.
And so the community stood up, and now they went back to some supporting local artists. So when you go to the Bay, you're going to hear some E-40, you're going to hear some Mac Dre, you're going to hear the artists that come from that community, right? Because the community came out and spoke.
I just think we don't know how powerful we can really be. Like, to me, when the NBA players did that stance at the ESPYs, mm-hmm. it was so dope that it shouldn't have been that dope, that it should have been a regular thing that happens all the time.
Right.
That those dudes should have stood up the first time a black man got killed in their city. No, like when you go.
LeBron does, and no, I'm not saying they don't. They have stood up when stuff is
happening. But Dwayne is from Chicago. I'm not saying you can't stop everybody from getting shot. You cannot do that.
No,
but at least
saying.
If you go, hey, my man, we doing this thing where you bring a gun, you get a ticket to my game. You stand up like that, and that may have caused one young man not to be killed, or somebody in their house not to catch a bullet from that particular gun.
Right.
And we used to have those programs, and I don't know if they still do it anymore. And I just think places like Chicago, if I had that kind of power, I would do that here in my city, right? Because I don't want to see nobody get shot over some stupid shit or shot. Period.
Right.
Because if somebody wakes up and go, "Nigga, you fuck you," and then next thing you know, you shooting him, miss him, and you hit the baby.
Right.
It had nothing to do with that. You know what I mean? So I think as a society and as being black folks, we just have to understand how powerful we really are, what we can really get done. If we really all went and voted, and some people don't believe in the vote shit, but that's all we got. So it's not like.
Say that's all we got.
I'm saying that's all we got to make a change. You can't vote for nobody else. It's not going to work that way. The system's not set up that way.
There's two black women running for president right now.
They're not going to win.
Let's see, but everybody didn't think that Barack, and people thought that Barack wasn't going to win either.
No, I knew he was going to win.
No, but see, that's funny that you say that
now.
I
knew he was going to win. I voted.
You know, I voted too.
I voted too.
But my point is this. Don't say that we are not going to win, because that's not true.
And not saying that's all we got, because that's not true.
That's not true.
I'm saying as far as making a change.
No.
Okay, what else?
Disagree.
Is there another
the
way?
Economics, just the few things that YZ
no,
said.
No, what I'm saying is, if you don't vote for if you don't vote for Hillary, then he wins.
Okay, listen.
Then Trump wins. That's all we got.
It's already.
You can say
it's
that.
Already,
no, it's
yes, it is.
It's, no, it's not.
Yes, it's already
not.
Set up.
That's just
believe
one way
me,
to look at
that's
it.
That's how I look at yes, it. It's already
and
designed.
And that's fine
that's
for you
why
to look
it's
at
all. It's a setup.
But boy, it's okay it for you to look at it like
okay,
that.
It's
but,
set up to all
whether we vote or not, Hillary
vote.
Or whoever they
still
chose is going to be in office, period.
I don't believe it. So just like you don't believe it, I don't believe it.
But listen, you know what? You said something earlier, and you asked me. You said, well, what can we do? Well, why would you put your money in a black bank?
Okay.
Why would black people unite, really unite? See, unite just means that we are basically in one particular pool agreeing on a particular thing, or being able to disagree in a way or form of fashion where we can walk away from that particular situation still healthy, alive, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So why would we put all our money in a black bank? Mm-hmm. Why do you protest and not go to like a Target or a Walmart? Why do you do that? Well, the same reason we would do it is the same reason that other ethnic groups would do it. You know, if you stop shopping at Target, let's say a month, let's say 2 months, Target themselves will come to our community and ask us, what is it that they want from us to do? Well, okay, what do we want them to do? Do we want them to make their prices lower? No. What you want them to do is to lobby for us. You want your vote to count. Mm-hmm. Lobby for us. We're not getting. Barack made a lot of promises to us. Those promises have not been kept. Okay? Why are they not kept? Because we are not a force to be reckoned with. We're a force We're just not a force to be reckoned with.
I think you guys are missing the point. Okay, let me get this out. Now, to be president, you can't do it if you don't have the Congress. Hold on. If you don't have the Congress on your side, you need to have it can't be a Republican because they can stop everything he wants to put through.
I am not one of these persons to bash Barack. I like him.
No, I'm with you.
I'm not bashing him. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is simply he made promises.
But they're stopping those things from getting through.
No, hold on. Well, think about it this way. You're saying that basically Barack couldn't do what he wants to do.
Because.
Well, hold on.
The filibustering and all that.
You know, they got this thing that they keep calling, what is it, the health care, the Barack.
Obamacare.
Obamacare.
Which is actually their shit.
Yeah, for sure. It definitely came from a Republican first.
Sure did.
But when Barack embraced that, they fought against it.
Yes. Because the black man embraced it.
Hold on. My point is this. It got through anyway.
Barely.
It got through anyway. So don't tell me you can't make promises to your own and you can't keep those promises. You know how he's trying to make it up now? He's trying to make it up with student loans.
I would be happy with that.
I just don't think he could, because he's a black president, we take the thing like he need to look out for us. Sometimes we need to look out for ourselves.
I'm not saying that Barack is my savior. I'm not saying that. Mm-hmm. I'm saying you're a politician. Mm-hmm. Politicians, they run on things. They run on promises. There's a way to make a person follow their promises, and then there's a way to kind of just give those things away. We as a whole. Mm-hmm. We don't pool our money. There is no. Well, I don't have to keep my promise.
But we're going to start with the black banks.
Well, you have to start there first because you have to do that. But then again, Target, Walmart.
Well, you made the best sense. I got all those texts, people telling me to boycott Target. Why y'all want me to boycott Target?
Don't make sense to just boycott
them. Don't tell them we boycott. Now we boycott them. They don't know
sense.
We boycott.
Yeah, that don't make sense.
So what you just said made me say, I said, ding, ding, ding. I said, maybe that's what they were trying to do.
If you're going
to
boycott, you're going to boycott for reason.
I've only been here twice, but you probably know I don't like to talk about problems and what people are doing wrong because it's a waste of time and the energy for me. Right. I like to talk about solutions. I mean, even what I do, making a living as I do, is because it happens here first.
Right.
My thoughts. And I believe that all of us need to change our thinking and we can change the world and it won't matter what he, she, them, they do. And I also think what you just said, that was good about the Target, but we don't know what we want.
I was going to say, are we organized enough for all that?
Because even if they came to us, Target came and said, okay, what do you want us to do? Well, could you sell black tennis shoe?
That right there, we need to, if you were to ask me what we need to stop doing, we need to stop doing that. We need to stop saying that we don't know.
Because that's why I asked you, my brother, what do I do? Told me homeschool my child. I'm a working mother. I'm a single mother. Then you told me, what else you tell me? Homeschool my children. Take away the TV. I'm on television. They're going to see me. Take away the computer. They got to do a lot of work on computers. And sometimes I say, oh, baby, you shouldn't be on the computer. That's what I'm thinking. You need to be out playing. But I think back to when I was a child and my mother wanted me to stop doing something. And now if I had kept on doing it, I'd probably be making money on the computer. I don't know. But my baby's balancing. Right. My son would throw the football in the backyard that's so big. I have to say, don't throw the ball over the house. Don't hit the ball in the neighbor's yard. So I still, walking out here today, I like listening to you.
Right. I like
what. Knowing what to do is what I've been doing, which is instilling.
You said, hey, I'm a single mother. I can't homeschool my children. Homeschooling doesn't necessarily mean that you have to do it in your home. Let's just say there is a community of people.
Then I ain't homeschooling.
That's not true.
Then I'm sending them over to Smiley's house.
Smiley. They haven't known you for 35 years.
Here's the difference.
I love you.
They ain't gonna learn shit in my house. I can tell you.
Let's say you were the teacher.
But you know what? If I teach my children to love themselves, and if I teach my children the power that they have, they have power, mastery, and dominion. Yeah. It don't matter what nobody says. I don't. Man, and if I keep my children from being fearful, I don't tell them.
I know if you pull your top up one more motherfucking time, this conversation going to go bad.
I'm sorry.
Why, see?
I'm sorry.
What
I'm
song
sorry.
Do you got for us?
I don't know what you're about to play. You about to play something on mine?
I want to hear your music.
I want to hear the hit first.
Yeah, give me the hit first.
What's the hit?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Okay.
And then I want to know, have you ever told a guy his suit looks nice?
Look at me.
He hurt.
How do you say it? How do you say it when you say it?
If
Speedy had on a nice suit, what would you say?
I don't necessarily know if I would just go to every man that has a nice suit on and be like, hey, brother, your suit looks nice.
See how that shit sounds?
But hold on. But say my blood brother came. Okay. Let's say we were going to a wedding.
Yeah.
And we both had on suits and he looked sharp. I'd be like, bro, you look real sharp.
Okay. That's his brother. But the random nigga you saw walking down the street.
Yeah, I ain't just going to stop some man on the street because he's sexy in that suit.
You can't say
that. That might not be too nice.
I might in my mind go, that's a nice suit, but he'll never know I said that.
Okay.
I'll just be like, what's up, nigga? You always got to go, what's up, nigga?
The sniff is the compliment.
Yeah, that's where he know I'm not really mad. I go, what's up, nigga? Yeah, you gotta do that, and then you go, oh, it's cool. But if I just go, what's up, nigga?
Oh, right.
Then it's a beef about to happen.
Okay.
Nigga, get him up.
I see.
But if I say, what's up, nigga?
Let me hear your what's up, nigga.
I don't talk like that. At least not out.
Only in the song.
Only on record.
Hey, bitches!
Well, YZ, tell everybody where they can follow you.
Yes, please.
And we'll play some of your music on a break. And really enjoyed your conversation.
Yeah.
I really didn't talk about
shit.
Anything I was doing.
Oh, my bad.
What are you
but
doing?
That's cool,
tell
though. Yeah,
no,
just,
no,
just holler at your boy.
No, let us. No, hold on. What are you doing?
I'm having fun with y'all right now. That's all. To be honest with you, I love being here. Hopefully you'll be able to have me back and
absolutely.
We can talk about it later.
No, go ahead. You can talk about it now.
Anyway, you say you're going to play Master Plan?
Nah, I really want to know what you're doing. Tell me two things that you're doing.
I have a clothing company. I told you about real estate already,
yeah, you
right?
Did.
Clothing
you,
company.
You did.
Yeah, you said about the real estate. You have a clothing company.
You did put
company.
Us in our place about real estate. Go ahead.
Put you in your place?
Yeah, you let us know you're rich.
Yeah, you
know, it's funny.
Rich.
You ain't going to put your button. And that's another thing we could do, too, though.
Yeah, what? You buy
land.
Yeah, I
met Oprah, and that was one thing she did instill when she was having a conversation with us. She said buying land is the one thing that black folks need to do.
Period.
I agree.
And even if
they don't make no more land.
Even if we pull our money and do it,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine like if 100,000 people just put $10 in a pool
$10
mm-hmm. in a pool just to go buy some land that they can, you know.
Well,
now
I'm gonna give you
do
something.
It.
I don't
Let's
know
do
if you know it or not. Now in other countries, especially in Japan, if you're not Japanese, you cannot buy land. Like
really?
If you moved to Japan,
well, but
you
Japan
wasn't
is
born
small,
and raised.
But you understand why?
But though. If you, yeah, I understand what they were perfect about.
Well,
if you're not born and raised a Japanese, you cannot buy land there.
But
at
the
all.
Reason they do that is because the place is this big.
Yeah, yeah. But
that's
but
still,
I like that thought though. Here we sell shit to whoever. Fuck, you don't have to be American.
Well, we sold okay. stuff, drugs and.
Wait a minute, your clothing line.
It's 88 out of Utah.
AD
880. The number 80.
80.
Okay. In Utah. Anyway.
Do you use American people, black people?
For sure. For
American
sure.
made.
Well, the funny thing is I use white people too. I don't
they,
want you
they
to
make
think
shit
that
too.
I just. Look,
check.
I'm not one of
they
these persons. Like,
too,
I, look, I'm just not saying checking. That we can't work with them. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that at the end of the day, realize where your strength lies. If you can't realize that first, then what happens is they got a way of coming in your pool like a shark and eating everything that you have and will do it with a smile on their face straight up and down. Like I know people like that.
Give you information.
Instagram, YZ, the number 4 real, Facebook,
all of them.
Facebook, you know, the real YZ,
Twitter,
real YZ,
what's the name of the new album?
Well, the one that you're listening to now or about to listen to is called Muad'Dib. The one I'm working on right now is called Gods and Villains.
Ooh.
Pam, you're a villain.
All right, so let's get into some
YZ. You ain't
YZ,
no God, that's
and
for
thank
sure.
you for hanging out with us.
YZ in the building.
Look, I appreciate y'all having
thank
me.
Thank you.
Man,
that's great.
We'll be back
I like
this.
The way y'all think.
Hey, oh, thank YZ. You.
Who's Speedy? We'll be back.
Especially Smiley.
minus, as I was told. Everything that he touched turned to gold. He's the greatest of the great. I get it straight.
Y'all are back.
Myself.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
It is the all new Rollout Show. It's your boy Speed Doug. Doug, and you just blew it. What the fuck are you doing? No, okay, there. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the building. I'm Speedy. We're not doing affirmations.
I'm the poetess.
Nikki Pam.
Tangi Ambrose, heaven high.
Energy level lower. sitting in the room with us right now, very talented people. We have on this side.
Oh, Marcus Paul.
I was going to
Marcus. Oh.
No, go on.
You did point at him.
I did point at him.
Yeah, I didn't know if that was go.
No, you good. From Moesha, from who I've been knowing since he's a little dude, because I used to do the warm-up over there.
So?
Yeah.
And now he's a grown-ass man. Well, kind of.
Yeah.
He's in his 20s.
I made it.
The last movie we did, which was...
Sister Code. Sister Code was the last one.
Sister Code.
Yeah.
Very good movie. But I'm talking about the...
Oh, Red Tails.
Red Tails was a beast,
yeah,
brother.
That was so good.
That was... I was so happy to see you a part of that, man. And even though... Again, because sometimes, all right, brother, again, come back, man. Please come back. As black people, we just have to say negative shit about some things. And I got on a lot of people who tried to be negative about that movie, Royal Watkins. So I got in his ass because I refuse. I hate when we do that because when black movies come down the pipe and they ain't about niggas killing and all that other stuff, and it's a great movie, support it. I don't give a fuck how you feel about it, whether it was told the way you thought it should be told. You ain't got no fucking money to get
the
movie.
Yeah, I feel like people kind of missed the point of that whole situation. Yes. George Lucas really couldn't find people to support that film, and that was like his baby. He's a huge World War II vet, and you know, George, his wife is an African American woman. Mm-hmm. He's a real person, really cool dude, very humble. You know what I mean? And he really, really believed highly in Red Tails, and the story needed to be told. He did have conflict in with like what he wanted to do with the script because he wanted to be able to not make it such a sob story, because it's true that, you know, there was instances with those Tuskegee boys that, you know, kind of messed up. But he wanted to shine the light more so on the heroic factor, and he wanted to still keep the movie fun and playful so the teens could be interested. So he went through a big battle with that, but he put up his own money to make that film because he couldn't get support in Hollywood. He put up $50 million to make that film.
Wow.
So when a movie's positive like that film and historical and for people of our nature to go see it and support, and we miss that opportunity, people forget that that takes a toll on our future projects.
Yeah, because Hollywood
is about money.
But
people will run
out
and go see Straight Outta Compton and let that movie make $200 million, and there's no positivity there at all.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's just people, I think, sometimes are confusing. Like y'all were talking about earlier, is people's state of mind and what they understand and how things play out. So that was kind of a sad thing to see, that everybody didn't run out and flood that, because that movie should have made $100 million in the box office.
And what people should understand about Hollywood, they're about green. At the end of the day, they believe in green. So when a movie does well, I don't care fuck what it is.
They'll copy it.
They'll copy it and keep doing it because they go, that's what people want.
What
the minute it does do well, and we already know now, for those who don't know, when black movies go overseas, they don't do that well. And the studios really base their money off of overseas money.
Yeah,
that's why they always add white dudes in with the brothers, so that it'll be watched overseas. They're very prejudiced overseas. Mm-hmm. They don't want to see nothing black. They just don't. They don't, unless it's like movie like Wetchcom, what they did. But when you're doing a movie, and we're doing a movie called Star Weekend, Jamie's been told, he's directing it, that you need to have a white character if you want to make this stupid money overseas. Mm-hmm. And that's where the studios make that extra money to buy a boat, buy shit for their kids and the kids' kids, because they make $100 million overseas. So that's just thought. Also in the building we have.
I love all my overseas fans.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Thank you. Okay, can I introduce this sister
please,
right here?
Please.
She is beautiful. Can I say that? I'm allowed to say that because women can say that. Her name is Nikki Allen, y'all, and she has designed this Give Me Body Swimwear. Give as G YV. She is redefining beauty by creating swimwear for real women with real curves, all shapes and sizes and stages of beauty, and she will custom fit that joker for you. And if you want to schedule a fitting, just call 855-550-4100, and you can reach her at www.givemebody.com. That's GYVEMEBODY.com.
That's why I let her do it. I would have fucked that right up. I'd have been like, show your love for Nikki. I don't know why she wrote all this shit. Nikki's in the building.
And like, they were at Palm Springs with us, and we met them
her
before.
And Amber. I just saw Amber.
Oh, and look. And look, we got gifts. Okay, yeah, wait a minute. Gifts. Wait a minute. I want to open mine. Let me see what I got. Let me see. Ready? Ready?
Hold
here we go.
Hold on. The dudes didn't get shit? We don't get shit?
For what?
Okay, ready? 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 Woo! Oh, my God.
That's cute.
And I got, it goes with my skin.
You put it on? Can you guys put these on there? Get right on that
did
mic,
I get
Nikki. She's about to give it to you right now.
Yes.
Get right. Now, what is the, what are we looking at? What is this?
So these are, it's called Bahamas. Oh. And so you can wear this as a cover up
get
or
closer.
As
closer.
Lingerie or just
because.
Goes with my skin complexion.
Yes. It's made out
look
of a sheer stretch chiffon.
And you made these?
These are my designs, one of many, one of our first designs from the first line. And it's a very popular piece because you can wear it over leggings, you can wear it over swimwear, you could wear it as lingerie again.
How about if I just want to, you know, throw it up over your back? And
whatever okay. turns you on. All
right. This nigga.
Oh, and look at this.
I bought a black one last year. Yeah.
That's how dudes think. We gonna buy something that's easy access. You gonna get the easy access shit, right?
Yeah, I like
easy
to wear
access
dresses. And,
yeah,
you know,
sundresses is my shit.
Oh, I love the sundresses.
Oh my gosh. And if they thick with the,
I haven't seen too many sundresses this year. Like, is it too hot? Is it too hot for the sundress?
No, he's supposed to wear it.
Oh, did you put it on?
I haven't seen
it. I think he's supposed to take the stuff underneath off. You know, that's what you just wrote to me and said. You said, tell him to take it off.
Oh, and look at the sleeves.
Now you got movement.
What? I'll be like, hey, girl.
like a moth now. All right, that's
love it,
Marcus. I think that is easy access. That's easy access.
That's the
it is,
that's
the and the way it's cut, it like curves in with your figure. You know, look at that.
So you're looking out for the sisters when you make
absolutely.
These outfits.
Okay, cool. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, do you have a certain model that you use? For
yes,
most of your stuff?
My favorite bombshell is what I call her is Amber Hairston. And
this Amber.
This Amber.
Man.
The lovely Amber.
In another life. God damn.
Yeah, you Speedy's flavor all day long, Amber.
Yes, yeah. We'd have 13 kids. They'd be, look, they're going there and clean up now. Shit. Your mama busy. She modeling shit.
little smiley, little spanky.
Try.
Little sippy, all of them. Yeah, she is, what would you say? That would be curves? Major curves. She has major
absolutely.
Curves.
Absolutely. Amber, I call her a bombshell because she has the total package. She is full up top. She has a smaller waist. She has hips. She has.
I could have described that.
Thighs.
She has thighs. She's tall. She's 6 feet flat.
Pretty.
She has beautiful
and a sweetheart
skin, and she has a bubbly.
Yeah, guys ain't looking for that.
Inviting personality.
Man.
You don't want anybody mean.
Well, hey. Sometimes you take me when it's, you know.
Right, was good, say it.
The package right, nigga. I can get rid of mean. I can't make you look cute. You
like they want to see Amber.
Come here,
Amber.
Can you come behind? Please, Amber.
Yeah, she's, yeah.
Maybe go between Speedy and them.
Yeah, come between me. Right, always come between me. No, you don't
nobody else. Yeah, I think
Amber's in the, say hi, Amber.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. She's cute.
Now, are you single? Are you single?
I'm sorry?
Now you can't hear. Are you single?
I am single. Single, ready to mingle.
With the cute little tattoo, to thine own self be true. I love it.
Who is eating?
Turn around. Nobody. Turn around, Amber, so they can see you from the backside.
Oh, Portis.
Yeah, buddy. Y'all see that? Y'all see that? Bam.
So when you make the outfits, this is what your template?
No, not necessarily this is my template, but this is one of our clients. So when I say real women with real curves come in all sizes.
Mm-hmm.
There are women that are size 6 that are curvy. There are women that are size 20 that are curvy, and in every size in between. So I've been working in the industry for over 20 years, and what
the labels that I worked for did not cater to women of curves. Mm. And so I found that we were being left out. And in particular, with swimwear and activewear and things that were made to fit the body. And so you want your bottoms to cover your crack of your...
Not really.
I wanted to show want a little to, bit. Except for Speedy.
Except for me. Well, Marcus, you wanted to cover up the butt?
No, I mean...
Truthfully.
I'm with you on that. So,
well, I can tell you many times I have gone to get a swimsuit and the top won't, you know, it'll be one size and the top won't fit because I got these itty bitty titties and the bottom will, or vice versa. Like I was saying, when I go shopping for clothes, I get frustrated because it's like, oh my God, I got this horrible body because nothing looks good. But when you custom make it for our, because most of us look good naked, right? Don't we? Don't you feel like you look better naked than you do with clothes on?
Amen.
Be careful.
I do. Okay. I agree.
I do.
Agree. Well, what we do is we offer mix and match. So, for instance, you would be small on the top and maybe a large on the bottom, and vice versa. You have women that are fuller on top and smaller on the bottom. And then also we offer our custom body collection, which means that you can choose your own silhouette and style, and then we would custom make it to fit your
curves. Someone's in Chicago listening to the show and they wanted an outfit made.
Yes.
How would you do that?
So you could go to our website, which is givemebody.com.
GYVEMEBODY.com.
I have to correct her. It's actually
GYVEMEBODY. GYVEMEBODY.com.
Yes.
Gimme.
Yeah.
Gimme.
And so you would go to our custom body collection page, and then you could choose a silhouette. You can choose if you want it to be halter or tank, if you want it to have padding or no padding, if you want it to be a thong or cheeky bottom. Or
what is cheeky?
Cheeky means you just show a piece of the cheek.
Can you show me on? I just want to know. This is research. I'm actually doing research. I want to know what cheeky. So just a little,
that little peak, that little about.
Just
that
a little see it. Like
yeah, just a couple inches like inch of the bottom of.
I don't measure by inches. Look here.
Speedy, you know she's on YouTube too, so maybe you can see sisters moving in the swimwear. You can. We actually do have a few videos on there, Women in Motion. And we try to also be very current on Snapchat as well.
Now, I have both of you guys on because Marcus is doing a fashion show this week. And is this your clothing?
No, I don't have any clothing line yet. But I do run a booking agency for models now called Model Mafia LA. So I put together this event with my business partner because we've been doing these things called Model Mix Sundays, basically, where I get all the models to sign up, inspiring models and girls that are like up and coming who don't have huge like followings and stuff like that. And we set a platform for them where we do it at an exotic location like Hollywood Hills Mansion. We did Malibu, a couple other places. And they come, the photographers are there. We have the hair and makeup for them. We feed them and we have everybody come do executions and shoots at the locations.
Amber would be?
Amber. We do all shapes and sizes. We don't discriminate really unless you're just like, why are you here to be why are you trying to be
so a girl shows up, she's a real hard sell. And she goes, I can do it, but you know.
Well, there's a registration fee. So if she has the registration fee, she can usually do like, you know, we'll set up shoots for her. But sometimes when we do executions as a group, some people may not make the executions. But actually, we've been pretty good about having everybody involved, and everybody's been pretty good
and
looking.
And she maybe could be a hand model.
So it's been very good. Yeah, I mean, there's all types of different models.
Yeah, she can hand nigga shit here.
I mean, we have about 60 plus models already.
Wow.
The event is actually Sunday the 31st downtown at the Reserve. We have Miss Nikki Baby from Love and Hip Hop LA is hosting, and also her line's gonna be in it. We got Moschino. We got a bunch of other
you know I host lines. Right. You know I do hosting.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, you can always come through. So you can get up there. And
I like hosting a ladies' fashion show because for those who don't know, when you walk through the back, they don't care. They just get undressed.
Just naked.
And the first time I ever did one and the girl just dropped her shit, I said, so.
This is what it is.
She was like, hey. I was like, hey.
So I love my job. Yeah, I love my job. But no, the event's going to be really dope. I
think, again, it's located where?
The Reserve downtown. That's 650 South Spring Street. Mm-hmm. It's going to be an amazing event. We got Chris Brown's best friend is performing. And,
Chris Steve Brown's best friend.
Steve Brown. I have a business partner who gets all these people's technical, you know, but we have a bunch of people coming out, and it's going to be an amazing event.
It's Nikki, baby.
So this is part of what you do. You're still acting? Have you started directing or producing?
Actually, I'm working on getting into some producing. I just co-produced a short film recently, and working on setting up some invoices for this production of this other reality show for these guys out of Africa. They're trying to do kind of like a African version of The Bachelor. So I'm probably going to be helping them produce that.
So you've been in the business since you what? What age?
I was 4 when I got in the business.
Because I've been knowing your mom forever, man.
Yeah. Great.
And I remember when I would do the warm-up on the show, she was like, just say something. Ask Marcus a question. See, when they yell cut, then the actors, some are still on set. And so, you know, the parents and his mom was always hands-on. Speedy, could you ask Marcus the same?
I was always turned up. I was always trying to come up with an audience. And I'm trying to dance.
So we got music playing. And I didn't have to ask Marcus. He already up there. I said, he's here now. Your son's doing flips on the stairs. Right there.
Turned up.
They had to get him all. Marcus, come on back. We're ready to shoot the scene.
Yeah. It used to be fun.
How was it working with Brandy back then?
It was good. I loved everybody on the set, yo. It was like one big family. It was real, like a real family. You know, you have your times and it's good, and then sometimes it's crazy, you know, and everybody has their days, right. I would say, you know, and you have to expect that when people have so much on their plate and stuff like that. But other than that,
did you feel like the microscope was on you being a child star? I mean, starting so young, did you feel like you know they held you to a different standard than say
you want to? You can sit in my lap if you want.
I feel like
not like I need to say that.
Well, I feel like in that position where you're at, you're kind of automatically considered somewhat of a role model or an influential person.
Right.
So I always try to keep a certain standard to myself, but also still be me. I can't really like let other people determine on who I'm supposed to be.
Yeah, he's at Jamie Foxx party.
That's what Speedy got.
Yeah, you know.
You had a good time.
Yeah, we had a great time.
Sure you
don't try to be modest now.
Oh, I had an amazing time. I had an amazing time.
I couldn't even get his attention. Oh, yeah. I was working the bar.
Somebody snatched me up.
Marcus. He's like, I'm busy. Yeah, I'm getting
it was
models.
Good. He was modest. Society.
It was good.
Do it again.
It was a good night, man. I think, it was good. It ended up a good night.
So you're single now.
Yeah, I'm actually single at the moment. Yeah.
All right.
You just getting out of a relationship?
Yeah, actually, I am.
How long?
It was like 2 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Did she have a problem with you being around all those pretty models? Was she just...
Yep.
Oh gosh!
Yeah, it gets a little. Because
I know how women are in that situation. So these bitches is gonna come now and smiling at you. You be like, no, they're on the show.
Yeah, I need a confident woman. Not to say that she wasn't. It's just everybody sometimes, you know, got to take their time.
I used to tell people when we would date, I was like, yo, I'm a comedian, so people going to walk up to me is going to be hectic. Mm-hmm. It's going to be situations where I'm not going to be able to be around you. Because some women, I would take them to the warm-up show, and I got to do my thing. Mm-hmm. I took this one girl. She's like, so you just not come sit with me at all? No, bitch. Like, I'm busy. I'm working.
Yeah.
So I usually do it that way, and that's how I would weed them out. If they couldn't handle that, you're not going to handle the Jamie Foxx party. You're going to take an L on that motherfucker.
Right, exactly.
I'd be doing my thing at that party.
Exactly.
So would you rather date women in the business who know your business or somebody out, totally out, and just...
Ooh, that's a hard one.
I've had
both, I would say, and they can work. I like girls that are just a little bit more open-minded, I guess, with understanding of what it is.
Yeah, uh-huh. What does that mean?
What does that mean?
Exactly.
Basically,
open-minded.
I like girls that like girls, too.
Let's write this shit down. Marcus, he just
the show just got real. Took a turn.
Bitches are like, I'm gonna redo it the right way. Bitches that like bitches.
There we go.
It makes it easier because then you can invite her in for a threesome or something.
Yeah, threesomes.
Usually they're not gonna sweat you as hard.
Yeah, because if a girl likes girls, she can appreciate another woman's body. She might be checking her out before me. You know what I mean? And
then she bring you in on.
Yeah, and then bring me in. Like, did you see her, babe? I'm like, oh, I didn't even see her, even though I'm out of seeing her. But it's okay. But it just depends on what you like, and you know, I like intimate relationships with somebody, but at the same time, I like them to be able to have some fun. I'm still young. I'm still young.
Yeah, no, he's 29.
Yeah, I don't have he any kids yet.
He in his prime.
He still think it's going to work out. It's beautiful. It's
got hopes and dreams.
29. Yeah, you, we, hey, nigga. I know, man. It ain't going to work out for me.
Yeah, it's over.
Pretty much what it is, what it's going to be. So you're do you, now have you done any fashion shows or you have anything coming up like that?
Well, we just finished up with Palm Springs.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And you guys did well then.
We did.
Yeah,
it was a lot of women trying on swimsuits.
It was very, very busy. I love that kind of action. Mm-hmm. Amber and I are very hands-on. We like to fit each.
You look great on the picture.
Each lady individually when we do those type of things. We like to do trunk shows, pop-up shops in particular.
What is it called again?
Trunk shows.
I never heard of that.
We know.
Yeah, it's like just different places. You know, you can also get a booth at our fashion show, too, if you want to come out. It would be really nice. There's going to be a lot of people there, a lot of attendees.
See how that works? See how it worked this
year? Synergy. We got synergy going on.
What's it called? Yeah.
Synergy.
Although they like being in the middle, but okay.
Ladies, please check out her website because these bathing suits are fabulous.
They're really great looking.
They really are.
One thing that I want to share with the ladies is that we do sizes small to 4X. So don't feel
I've had some 4Xs in my life.
Something for you. We really do have something for your curves.
What about women that are top heavy?
Yes.
We cater to
built-in bras.
So we offer cup optional.
Let's explain. Let's go on the cups.
Okay. So, for the women that are fuller on top, they usually like some added support. So we offer adjustable straps so that you can lock and load, which is what we call it.
Mm. Can you talk slower next time, please? Lock and load. Now, these are, because I know I've dated women, they have bigger. They like the straps to be a little wider, right?
Well, look at
Some of them.
So it doesn't make the index.
It depends on, like she said, if it's the crisscross ones in the back or something, you don't need it to be as wide.
So we have a particular style called Catch One and Catch Strings. And so with Catch One, it has double straps. So there's a strap that goes from front to back, and then there's a strap that crosses over in the back so that you have the double support, and all four straps are adjustable.
Mm. Oh, that's good.
Yes.
Or do you have the work? Because I'm very good at the...
little one hand. You gotta have that one.
Man, it take a minute to learn, but when you learn it, it's a beautiful thing.
If you end up with a struggle with a bra, I think it might mess up everything. It might mess up.
Yeah, she might go, you know what?
You know what moment?
I was right there.
You back with your teeth.
Hey, so do I just pull it together and then she go, never mind, I'm out. Damn. You know so you, as a dude, you had to know how you pinch and turn.
You just gotta pinch and turn. Snap a finger almost pretty much.
Yeah. If they come in a full, the sports bra, you like, nigga, it ain't going.
The struggle is real.
Yeah, by the time you roll that up, you change your mind.
You gotta get up under there.
You know, I don't think this is a good idea.
Just shut up. It is a good idea.
If you let me get this shit off. But the bra is called a what again? It's called a...
Well, we offer a couple things. So one is the adjustable straps. Mm-hmm. Another cup option is you can have padded cup for those who need a little bit of sizing added to them.
I am not doing any padding. You know the thing about padding? Because mine, they're cute. They're tiny, but they're cute. But I feel like if I do the padding and then we go home and he zips it off and he's like, oh, dad.
See, that's why girls always do that run to that
that's
bathroom.
That's why I don't wear bras.
That's why girls do that run to the bathroom every time.
Which is also sexy.
Yeah, I just don't. And then people have the nerve to complain because my nipples are showing. But I feel like if your boob's only this big, I mean, in Hollywood, I don't have any.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So,
Speedy, have you ever had those little rubbery things pop out on you?
Little rubbery things.
It's a thing that they put inside of the bra to make the padding.
And then the joints just like,
she forget to tell you.
Moving still?
Yeah.
Be moving when they hit the ground still like a fish.
You do your pop move and then everything pop out. You're like, hey, do you need these? This one has a nice nipple on it. It's salty.
Definitely salty. Got titty residue on it.
Unfortunately, I did date a girl who had, they was Miss Size.
Oh, Miss Size.
But she told me, she did tell me. She said, like I was going to change my mind. We already at the motel. You dated Biggie Smalls.
You dated Biggie Smalls, for real. That was a joke.
I'm already in the hotel. And since she goes, I have something to tell you. I'm like, you're not a dude. As long as you ain't a dude, I don't give up. She goes, well, one is really much bigger. And I said, well, okay. And then she took it off. And I was like,
it was much bigger.
I mean, but.
Hey, it's little still guy. Cool, yeah.
No, I was going like this.
Hey, little buddy.
This one is heavy.
This
one
is heavy.
And they were just, but I didn't dudes, once we there, now if you tell me in the car, I might be like, you know what? My mama just called me. I got to pick
her up. Like us with the picture.
I'm about to pick up my other homegirl. Is it all good?
So I'm not showing you nothing until it's time for you to see it. Then by the time you see it, it's done. I'm not putting it up.
This is one thing that I love about your swimwear, Give Me Body, because most of us look really great naked. Since you custom make these swimsuits, yes, then you can make them for my little body, absolutely, my little boobs, and they don't need pad because they make me look like I'm naked, but I'm covered.
Here's the mm-hmm. thing. We also have clients that are G cup, and a lot of people don't even know what a G cup is.
You do.
Okay, you have.
Well, that's all he dates.
I've dated G.
Okay,
G in a bowl.
So we had a couple G cup women this past weekend, and they were concerned if we had something for them, and we were able to fit three of them, and they bought on the spot and wore them there.
All right, sister.
Did they put them on there?
Yes, they did.
I was there. I didn't.
They did. I was sitting across from you. Remember?
God damn it! I left. Yeah, that's beautiful. So G cup, I've dated a G. Whoa.
And we do G cup with no underwire, mind you.
I was smothered. I had to come up with air. I had to go.
Because we've done some research that found that underwire actually has a lot to do with some of the breast cancer research.
Wow, I didn't know
so
that.
So we are anti wire.
So what are you putting underneath?
Or we use a lot of support fabrics. I use some of the best quality fabrics because I've been in the industry for a while. Fabrication is extremely important to me. Textiles are extremely important. So I'm not just going to buy $1.99 cotton. I would rather spend $25 per yard to get the fabric that is going to offer strong elasticity, four-way stretch that has a strong poly, spandex, and nylon blend.
So wait, did you just say the wire gives you cancer? Is that what you just said?
We did some research that found out that underwire, because it has the actual metal wire and you have lights and sun, and mm-hmm. it's like being in an x-ray machine. And you know how they tell you that you shouldn't be in an x-ray mm-hmm, machine for, mm-hmm. you know. And so the research has found that it is linked to breast cancer.
Here's the question. That's great. That was fucking mm-hmm. right. So women across the United States, they just text me and ask. Yes. So the prices on these bathing suits are?
The average price for custom swimwear is about $100, slightly over.
But you get it the way you want it.
Absolutely. And for you. Yes, of course.
It's worth it.
You can pick your fabrics. You can pick your colors. You can pick your detailing in terms of trims.
Like this is what?
That's a cover of this.
Oh, it's a see-through. You know what? This
$25.
Ron, we need to get one of these for the girl. Because I can see. You get out the shower with that on. Fuck this game. Pause.
And this is one of our cover-ups that is from the Cover Me Sexy portion.
Cover Me Sexy.
Yes.
I love that you have all these.
Bright, love naming them.
Bright colors, too.
I love naming the suits. They speak to me, so I give them names.
Give Me Body.
So how long have you been doing this? You seem like very passionate about it.
I am. I've been in the fashion industry for over 25 years. I actually also work for other labels in the industry as well. But the Give Me Body swim line is 3 years old.
Okay.
June.
Oh, good for you. Okay.
Black-owned business. Marcus has a new black-owned business. So if you're a model out there and you're cute.
You can go. You can reach us on Instagram. It's model_mafia_LA. And if you want to come out to our show, we should do some giveaway. I wanted to
give away some tickets. Go ahead.
Oh, if anybody's here, call us. The 323-293-3375. I got some tickets to give away.
There it is.
Right. What should we do? Some type of game?
Watch when they call in.
But I also want to offer to all of the ladies a discount. If you guys go on to our website and you order from our website, you can put in the code BODY, BODY, and get 15% off any order.
Ooh, that's www.gyvmebody.com. Give Me Body.
And again, the code is BODY.
BODY.
Code is BODY. You heard it here. 15% off. So that means, fellas, I'm telling you, if you buy nothing else for your girl, buy this, man. Somebody getting kids. Mm-hmm. It's gonna have a lot of baby batter on it.
Baby batter.
A lot of baby batter on this one.
Oh,
there's little Jimmy. Let me get him out. Little Speedy didn't make it.
Can I just say one thing? I also wanted to just chime in. She is extremely modest. She does so much of the work herself. She comes home from work. She has a full-time job. She does all of this herself. She works with one other woman. She is creating this swim line for women instead of outsourcing it like everybody else. That's why she needs to have a good again, black owned. She does everything. She has a room in her home
and support black. Yes. When I tell y'all, and we
like
talk
YZ
about
said.
We talk about, oh, I love being black. Here's a woman and a young man out here doing stuff for mm-hmm. us. Whether you think you fit it or not, or ask $100, sometimes you got to spend money on yourself. You got to go, I'm doing this for me, fellas. Your girl's birthday, something's coming up. This one right here, you gonna kill the game. Then you get her a swim outfit. So they take a picture of themselves, match it up on your website.
No,
they can do several things. They can reach out to me on Instagram, Facebook. They can send me a message. We also have an Etsy page.
We have an Etsy. Okay.
We have an Etsy.
What is that?
That's Etsy.com/shop/givemebody. And you can send me messages. A lot of ladies are just like, I don't know what size to pick. We also have a measure yourself tutorial on YouTube to show you how to take your own measurements. Hmm. You can send us pictures.
Can I help you out with that?
I'm very easy. It's very easy for me to size women based on a picture.
Me too.
I'm very visual.
Me too.
So if you show me what you got, I got something for you.
Okay.
It's just that simple.
And, I'm sorry. I'm excited. This is for me. And if I tell you, like, I want this one.
Yes.
So if you think, Tangie, that's not the one, would you say, now that's a great choice, but I have another one that I think might be good for your body type. I would love for you to.
You know what I do? Once I see the woman, I pull out several different options and I send them pictures. Okay. These are the ones that I feel like are best for you. Or what we can do is we can combine the top of this suit and put it with the bottom of this suit.
Mm-hmm.
That's where custom fitting comes.
And do I send you a picture of the front and the back or just the front of me?
I prefer front, back, and side, if possible.
Okay.
You know, because it's not a picture that I'm going to be sharing with anybody. It's just for the purposes
Me with the right swimsuit.
Absolutely.
Okay, I'm excited.
All right,
so again, give your information.
Thank you for having me.
No, give your information one more time.
Again, you can find us at givemebody.com, givemebody.com. We also have an Etsy store. It's etsy.com/shop/givemebody. We're also on Facebook, Give Me Body, Instagram, Give Me Body, Pinterest, Give Me Body, and Snapchat, Give Me
and
Body.
And the code word is?
Body. For 15% off.
Give your information.
And I'm Amber Hairston on Facebook. Antona Rose is my IG. And it's just been a pleasure to see you guys again. Thank you so much for having
us.
Thank you for having us.
My day has been brightening something.
Because
you're only about 20-something, right?
Sure.
Great answer. She said, sure.
Today.
Go with that one. 20-something.
All right, Ron.
No, I went. You going to take a break? Yeah, I went to. I had to go buy. No, I had to buy some liquor, and my man asked me for my ID, and it threw me off. I was like, motherfucker going to ask me? Oh, for the liquor. My bad. And he was like, no, sir. I was flattered, but goddamn. All right, we take a quick break. Come right back. Ron, don't move.
And I got your size.
Girl, you do.
I hardly ever.
Okay. We are back. It's the all-new rollout show. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the building right here at MorrisMediaLive.com in your meow. We played your song.
And they loved it in the chat room.
Yeah, man. Yeah, they hate everything.
Really?
Yeah. Man, them motherfuckers hate everything. They hate us. But they listen to us every day.
Thank you.
The shit out of us. So the fact they love you, that's way.
Yeah,
that's what's
up. How'd you get into
doing the music?
Yeah, because you know everybody goes, yeah, you want to sing.
No, yeah, right. I mean, well, music was my first love. You know, I started out dancing when I was four, Venice Beach.
Yeah, I
dancing
remember
and stuff like that. So music always been my first love. My dad and my uncle sang. They like won the whole championship in Star Search. My dad used to travel singing.
Who's your dad? Course,
my dad's name is Mark Polk, but you guys wouldn't know him like that. But he traveled like around the world singing. So like, no.
But, he didn't do it in the back. Oh, hey, yeah, number four.
No, he was pretty good. But
that's so sweet. You won on Star Search. I probably watched.
No, not me. My dad and my uncle.
Oh, your dad.
Yeah, they were called Twin Force. They were twins guys. It was the same year Jamie was on there.
Oh, really?
I think they were all at the championship there. I got a picture with Jamie then. I was like six or something. Aww. So
did you know acting was going to be you, or are you just kind of like, hey?
Well, I've always just been a high energy kid, so I attract the things that I kind of like speak on and say and want to do. I see something, usually it comes to me. So I used to always watch MC Hammer and Michael Jackson and be like, I wouldn't be able to be on TV and do what they're doing.
So remembering lines, was that easy for you? Or?
Yeah, it actually came pretty easy to me. My mom would work with me and stuff like that when I was younger, and then after a while, I kind of just got it, and it came pretty easy.
She was definitely a TV mom.
Yeah, yeah.
TV
yeah.
mom.
Momager.
Momager, yeah, but she didn't have me out here all messed up.
TV moms are totally different than any other. I mean, Orlando's mom, Orlando Brown,
yeah,
his mom, because they're over the top. They have to be sometimes, but they, man, you what you say about my son? What? Because your mom would be like, Speedy, did you say that? Did you say his name right? I said. Miss Pope, I think I said it right. Yeah.
And then likely he did.
And then Brandy's mom. Oh,
oh yeah.
God. Oh, no, Sonya don't play. Sonya ain't no joke.
It's levels to it. It's levels to it, we should say.
And Sonya, if you ever got Sonya mad, she's still mad at you.
Yeah, she's still
really?
Mad.
Sonya, okay, I'm going to give you the story. Y'all probably don't know. So we used to do this show back in the day. It was like an Apollo. It was a ghetto version we did in L.A. And so me and Jamie used to host. Mm. So one year, and it wasn't us, but the dude that ran it, he wanted Immature to win. Uh-huh. Brandy was on the show. Okay. Brandy was actually off the chain. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Brandy took second. Mm-hmm. So I don't know that Sonya thought I made the decision.
Oh. Is that when Brandy threw that book at Little Ron, the dude with the eye missing?
Might have been.
Oh.
So I go over to meet the producers to do the warm-up for the show, mm-hmm. and they went, Speedy? Because at the time I had already done In Living Color. So they knew I was great.
On point, yeah.
And they went, have you talked to Sonya? I was like, we cool. Now, I've been knowing Sonya since that shit.
Yeah.
And they said, nigga, she mad at you about something. Because it's up to her when you get the job. Mm. So I go over there, hey, Sonya. She went,
Uh-oh.
That sounds like her.
She said, nigga, you know what? I said, Sonya, what I do? Remember back when we used to do the Apollo Hollywood? I'm like 10 years ago? Or whatever it was. And she's like, yes, you didn't pick Brandy.
I'm sorry, I'm laughing. I'm sorry.
Sonya, I'm just
she
host.
Got a show now. Yes. It's all good.
Y'all have made it. Don't let this shit stop me. Right. I said, Sonya, let it go. She's like, mm-mm. So you want to do the warm-up?
Yeah.
They want to hire me, but they said talk to you. And she said, well, I guess we'll let you do it. But she was really mad.
Well,
me.
One thing I have to say for Sonya that I have to
beautiful
give her kudos
person.
On.
She cool as fuck.
It's She's cool.
It's levels you, to it. Yeah. But I think, you know, her sternness in that situation was necessary. Cause,
yes, yes. Because white Hollywood will run
Brandy
you through the wall.
Is, you know, still in a good position. Yeah. Ray J's okay. You know what I mean? And
hilarious.
Things are not making like, you know, mm-hmm. people aren't.
Now, I didn't see that happen. When I met Ray J, mm-hmm. he was just a little kid. Mm-hmm.
Carson.
I never thought, back in Carson, I knew them way back because I used to live in Carson. So I never thought he would become who he is.
Yeah, where they've taken their career to is amazing. Yeah. Sometimes it takes that sternness and a little bit of, you know what I mean? But
now,
yeah,
you have
she
kids?
Could, she needs some spa. Kid? No, no kids yet.
No.
You good?
Huh? No kids.
You good?
Do I want kids? I would want a kid. I would love to have a little version of me.
Take
at
your
some
time.
Point.
Take your
I would
time.
Love to have kids at some point, but right now I'm
now
enjoying.
Would you put them in the business? Knowing what you know,
if they want to do it, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's very scary. I don't know how I've made it so far without losing my mind.
Somewhere. My daughter wants to do it. She's already she's a Libra, and Libras are.
Oh yeah, I'm a Libra. October 12th.
See,
so,
one
yeah.
minute y'all cool as fuck. Next, like
you
if they
don't
join
tip
a church,
the scales. Don't tip
if they
the,
join
don't
the church, it. They either become it becomes a cult for them, or they don't go at all.
Yeah.
They can never do in between. And my daughter, she's 10 years old. She'll come in. She just don't. Look at her little love you. And she'll run upstairs.
Oh, that's
then she'll come back downstairs.
Females are different from the
and
male,
she go, I love you, Dad. I'm like, bitch, right.
That sounds more like a Gemini right there.
No. I'm a Gemini.
Four personalities at least.
Yeah. No, I'm all the same. No. I think it's the Pisces that are two fish, one swimming upstream.
Mm.
Geminis have four personalities for sure, at least.
My cousin does. Yeah,
at least.
Not me.
Yeah.
No. Mm. I think mine are all kind of, I mean, you know, there's my.
Yeah, just admitted that they're all there.
There's my Tangela and my Tangie, but they have merged together
Tangela
now.
And you, Tangie, but they have two people too, I'm sure, within themselves.
Okay, well, maybe.
And you're by yourself because.
Yeah.
Because I got two kids and I don't see myself being in a relationship with somebody until at least my daughter's out of elementary school. I just don't see how I could do that.
Now, you're in the business and you have two inspiring, very talented little ones. Do you see them or do you would want them to go into the business like
when,
you are?
When I first had my son, I had an audition and I breastfed both of my babies, 2.5 years each.
That's why
so,
they're not there.
They weren't there before
my mic
I
on,
breastfed.
My bad.
They weren't there before. But I had an audition and I went and I was auditioning and my children's father and my son were out in the back and the casting director was talking to me. Yeah, Tangie. She walked out and she saw my son. It was a show about kids. And she said, oh, we want to get him in the show. And told me what to do. I never took him. Because for me personally, like you say, unless they just really, really want it,
yeah, I was one of those
I want to get them that
like,
root. You know, I want them to be grounded and know they're special because I know when I'm on the show, it's like, oh my God, I love you, Tita. Mm-hmm. And when I'm not on the show,
not working.
They might not see me.
Yeah,
they don't see. And being a kid, having to balance that because kids can get caught up in thinking I'm always on TV. You always going to treat me a certain way.
Yep.
I said I'm hungry. Motherfucker, bring my food.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So did you ever get into that?
Did you have to adjust to that?
I've always been very self-sufficient.
Okay.
I knew how to cook my own meals at 6 years old, five. My dad was a chef also, before he was singing and stuff like that. You know, I was about like 6 or 7 years old cooking my own stuff. I had a little stool and I would go and make breakfast in the morning. Like,
seriously?
Yeah. I know how to
cook
very well.
See, but you're a perfect example of a lot of things. You really, really, really wanted to do this. It wasn't something that your mother made you do. It was in your blood.
And I still love it. Even, you know, it's been a roller coaster of you know, trying to make sure that you stay working in this business because of the elements that we deal with. Of course, we all part of it, so we know how it is.
Let me ask you, do you have a problem if someone goes, oh, that's the guy from Moesha, even though you've done other things?
It's all about the intonation of how they say it.
Okay.
If somebody's trying to
that's
be
the
like,
guy from Moesha!
Yeah, like, oh, what's up? Yeah, what's up? It's all love. But if you're like, oh, that's from Moesha, I'm like, that other shit, too.
Yeah.
Like, Tyron, who I put you guys
I
the same.
I love Tyron.
Tyron.
We are not the same because I've done my resume is.
They are not the same.
My resume is long.
But
they're not the same.
Thank you.
So me and Tyron were in Vegas.
Because what else has Tyron done except for Boys?
Menace
to Society.
I mean, Menace, my bad.
And Belly.
Black Panther.
Belly.
Panther.
Menace,
not Panther. I mean
Belly.
He was in Black
Tyron.
Panther.
I didn't know that one.
Yeah, he was in Black Panther.
Okay. So he did three movies.
And then he did a TV movie too.
And some with Jamie that produced.
And some
with Jamie.
So we go to Vegas and these sisters went, girl, that is him. And I hear them, but you know, Ty be acting like he don't hear shit. And they went, girl, that's him. Hey, is you I just fell on the ground. And Ty was like, yeah. But I know Urkel.
Mm-hmm.
You can't call him.
Oh, you can't call
him
that.
You
call him Jaleel.
Where I'm at now, I think over the years now, I'm starting to get the recognition and hearing people actually admit like how much of influence I was on them and how much the show meant to them and how they're actually so excited to see me continuing. So that is the beautiful part of what I do. And I know, like you said earlier, I was somebody who made people laugh. It's that return of knowing that I'm bringing joy to people is what keeps me motivated.
And you still getting them checks? They're like $45
now? Yeah.
$35?
You know, I have other projects. So forget. I got a lot of resistance coming in. I've been blessed to be in projects that do tend to run a lot.
Okay.
I've been blessed with that situation from you know, Moesha to movies like Roll Bounce, Take the Lead with Antonio Banderas.
Roll Bounce was good.
Certain ones like that, Red Tails, they continuously play these things, these projects. I've been blessed to be a part of those type of projects. So all I do is keep
in Red Tails, what did you learn that you didn't know before you did the movie?
Especially working with George.
No, no, about those characters.
The guys? About the Tuskegee Boys. Oh, my gosh, I learned so much that I didn't know. I mean, getting to talk to those guys face-to-face, it was such an honor. You know, with that film, we got invited up to the White House to meet Barack and
Shut the fuck
Oprah
up.
Did you get a picture?
Yeah, they had three screenings at the White House, and then Oprah had a screening. Tyler Perry had a screening. So I got to meet, like, all of the black elite, basically, in that whole circle.
How was it meeting Barack?
Yeah. It was really dope, man, Obama. Getting invited to the White House.
President
That email was pretty flossy. You know? Email from the White House. You're I think I made it.
Right, I know.
Is it you
out.
By yourself or you plus one?
When I went to the White House, it was me and I took my little brother.
Did you save the email?
I think I would have saved the email. Yeah, I still have the email.
I framed the shit out there.
And I got a bunch of dope stuff from them at the White House. They gave me a bunch of, like...
They gave you shit at the White House?
Well, they gave us, like, you know, honorary stuff from Obama and stuff like that. Because we became honorary Tuskegee Airmen after that project. So, that was a really great experience. That time, and you know, when we shot the movie, we went over to Europe for about 3.5 months. We were in the Czech Republic, and you know, they're still dealing with some of those issues over there overseas. There's still some racist people. We had a crazy experience because Neo had took us to the Beyonce concert. We went to the Beyonce concert, a couple of us, and then we left and we went to go eat at this restaurant. And at the restaurant, our waiter was racist. So when he came to the table, you know, they bring out this water stuff that you can, like, clean your hands in. And he told us, like, it was soup. And we're, like, looking at him like, what the fuck? And so then... he did something else, and one of the guys, Kevin Phillips and Elijah, they were trying to order, and he was just being really rude. And they're like, "Well, yo," what? And he's like, "You have to wait." And he just was being rude. And then he came over to the table, and he did like some white power shit. And
oh shit,
we turned that restaurant
upside down,
upside down a little bit.
And Neil's a cool dude.
Neil's cool dude.
Cool as a motherfucker.
But. Got up, me, Michael B, and, like, I mean, just threw this guy under the table. Then some of the guys in the kitchen came running out, and we were just, like, ready. Because Tristan was there, and I'm, like, with Elijah. So I stepped in front of them, and Mike B, he stepped in front of everybody, and Kevin Phillips was there. And it was a real experience, and it was very scary because we're down, like, three levels in this place in Europe. We're, like, seven African-American guys in Europe, Czech Republic, Prague, which is only, like, 20 years out of communism and stuff like that.
Now, the young man... That's in the black movie that's coming up. Megar Edwards, I think. He plays that, or is it?
Which one? Which film?
Which movie?
Oh, God. Because he's done a couple movies.
Your Story.
That's so good. He said the black movie that's coming up. We don't know.
He played Jackie Robinson and the one who played. Are you talking about him?
No, not him.
Oh, because I know he's got.
He was in the last Taken movie. Or not Taken. Sure. He was in the movie with Oh Boy, but when he was on the plane. And he played the black dude on
Speedy. We're missing it.
Yeah.
Anyway,
what was the point?
He's in the plane.
That he's getting a lot of work.
No, he's getting a lot of work.
Anyway,
you don't even know his name.
So, would you direct? Or is that something you want to?
Yes, I have a passion to be behind the scenes. Just because I've been involved so long, I've got to learn so many things behind the scenes that people, you know, go to school and pay so much money just to learn. And that experience that I have to kind of continue it on. I've been blessed to have great relationships and still have a great network of people where I can do that
and get projects done. Can you get stuff done?
Yeah, I know how to start to finish it. That's the beautiful thing I think about being in the business early is you learn how to be a team player. You learn what something start to finish is really like. You know, I think that's like one of the best moments is all the work I put into, like, when we're doing films and stuff like that, and then sitting back after it's all done and getting to watch that. All that work that you guys put in.
And who directed Red Tails again?
Anthony Hemingway. And I actually just got to work with him again on a pilot called The Infamous. And I worked with Nina, who was one of the producers, or the main producer on Hunger Games. So that's a big
thing. And you were able to just call him and go, hey, this is Marcus. You could just.
Yeah. I mean, I can
George
even.
Too?
Yeah,
like George,
I keep,
could you
I
call
keep George in
you?
My pocket as far as, like, if I need that call, I know I could call George because he's a good guy. He loves me. Him and his wife love me. Well, we had dinner up at Skywalker Ranch because he invited us all to the Skywalker
Ranch.
Yeah, that was when we first got to meet. We got to meet George, and we got to meet the Tuskegee Boys. So he invited us up and flew us out, and we were going to have dinner because Anthony's mom cooked this big meal for us, so we got to meet them. But when we were at dinner, I was just talking, we were cracking jokes, and I had said something about I think the Maury show. We were talking about like kids and not being the dad, and George and his wife were just dying laughing, and then they told me the next day, like, oh, we were up in bed still talking about what you said. And I was like, okay, cool. And then his son's a really, really cool kid, and he's into hip hop and everything like that. Really cool kid.
Well, because he's half and half, right?
No, he's not half.
It's all.
No, because they're not. His new wife is black. But I think one of his kids might be adopted, and then.
Oh, okay.
I think I met Oprah and being around, I called my mom when I met Oprah. We kicking it. Fox is, she's doing an interview with him. Mm-hmm. I felt her. That thing they say, when you're around Oprah, you feel like you can take the world over.
Yeah, because you understand you're that close to billions. When you're that close to billions,
and
you know that
she
you can
was
get
just
them.
Like, she seemed so regular. And then they got into a conversation, and Fox was talking about he had to fly somewhere, and she said, oh, you fly commercial? And and we all went,
and
oh,
then that shifted. Yeah, then you realize we're not on the same plane.
Yeah, yeah. And then then we get to talking, and then she was asking Jamie, you know, for Ray, or no, not for Ray, for the other movie he did where he was down on Skid Row, he had to lose all his weight.
Oh, yeah.
And she goes, how did you lose all the weight? Because me and Speedy want to know. And I went, hey.
Soloist, right?
Oprah? Hey, bitch.
I wanted
to. You wanted to. I know you did.
I was around Jamie when he did that movie, and seeing him in his element was definitely, he was definitely like, you know,
but it fucked him up too. Yeah,
it
fucked him up.
It did.
Because he had to go places he didn't want to go in his mind.
Right. And it was really dope to see that. And working on Red Tails, working with like Terrence Howard and Cuba. I got to work with those guys, and they're just amazing. Oh, Terrence is a great guy. He's
hilarious.
Why does everybody say that about Terrence? Terrence
is a eclectic type of person, and he's very different. He's not the same. I mean, as most people, but he is a genuine good guy. Genuinely a great guy.
Nigga, when he came and bought us his CD, that folk thing.
Oh, listen.
And Jamie said, "Yeah, we gonna put this in rotation." And he left, nigga.
I have a great story. So we're eating lunch on set, and it's me and the guys, a bunch of the guys, we're all together. Like, we had a great camaraderie because we had to go through military training and stuff. They broke us before we actually started shooting this movie. Like, we went through a 9-mile hike through the mud, waking up to explosion sounds, all types of stuff. Like, they really put us through boot camp. It was really intense. So we had a great brotherhood that came from that, all the guys. So we're eating lunch, and Terrence comes over, and he's like, I'd like to talk to you guys in the trailer. After you're finished eating, if you can come to the trailer, it'd be great. So we're like, what the hell did we do, man? Everybody's been on point. We like, you know, everything's rolling smooth, I thought. Like, so we're like, all right, whatever. So we go to his trailer, and Terrence is like, yeah, so I just wanted to, you know, I'm dating this lady now, and I wanted to play this song for you guys. I want you guys to listen and tell me what you think. So he whips out his guitar. And we're all looking at each other. We're all looking at each other like, is this really happening right now, y'all? So then he like starts playing the guitar, and he's like, I want to marry you. And we're all looking at each other, and we're just like, trying not to laugh, and just trying not to
Because he's serious.
Dead serious. Terrence is dead serious when he was singing this. And we're all looking at each other like, this is craziness right now. And we all exit the trailer, and we just all started kind of dying laughing. But I think he heard us. But
But
he's a great guy, though. I have stories for Terrence. In that 3 months, I have stuff that I would be like, Terrence. And then Cuba. Cuba is a party animal. I don't know if y'all saw that footage of him in Miami trying to eat the guy's phone.
Yes, I did.
So I have exclusive.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Fox Cube, right?
Fox called Cuba.
Yeah.
And
he's
like,
an animal.
Cube. So ever since the OJ shit, his shit blew up again.
Right.
He's
right.
Blown up again. Mm-hmm. So he's like, yo, man, Fox, I'm on set, but we gotta get it in. He was in Canada. He was shooting something in Canada. Oh, yeah, he's like, oh, you shooting American Horror Store?
He's on that.
Exclusive.
Okay.
You heard it here first.
Okay. That's right.
He's on the new set, new thing of American Horror Store.
He can do it.
So he was there filming, and he's like, I'll be home. We going to party. And nigga, that's all he was talking about was getting it in.
Man, we were out there, and oh my gosh, rolling around with Cuba is a fun thing to see. You know, because you know how it is like when you're the celebrity of the group. It's cool.
Okay.
And everybody knows it's you. But when you're with somebody who's bigger than you, and you get to see them go through it, it's great for us sometimes. Right. You know, we can sit back. It's fun. But, oh, my gosh, how the people love Cuba Gooding Jr., man. And he's just a great guy. And we partied in Europe, and he showed us the ropes. It was just, like, a great guy. Like, great, great energy. Him and Terrence leading that film for the lead guys. next to Nate Parker and David Oyelowo. Those guys are all great. You know what I mean? We had an amazing cast.
Yeah, yeah. The cast.
Was an amazing cast.
It was a great movie.
Yeah.
We all went together and saw it.
Yeah. Oh, we were talking about music, but that was My Time Is Money that we played earlier. That's in the film with Amber Rose. I got it placed in that film that I did with her sister.
Tell people how flawless she is.
Well, did you see me in the movie grabbing a booty?
Not yet. And I don't want to see that because I have my own visuals. Okay. I don't want to see you do it.
You got to go to Netflix.
We kicked it with her like all day one time.
Love Amber.
In Atlantic City.
Yeah.
And no pimple.
No.
I don't even think she had makeup on.
No.
And she was just, and cool
flawless,
as fuck.
Flawless and really cool chick.
Cool
like,
as
super down
fuck.
To earth. This it hasn't got to her.
She
head.
Know where she came from. She don't say she black.
No.
She knows she was born Trailer Park, and that's where they came from. Yeah. And she just happened to get a black body.
Yeah.
And that, she don't know how that happened. Yeah. But she tells how her and
but
her
she's
mama
mixed,
struggled.
She's not mixed. I
know
she's mixed a little bit, but she don't like. Yeah, she just keeps it where it's at. Yeah, she's.
But
real
she's
about it.
You know,
but sweet girl.
Give your information. Tell me about the thing this weekend.
I am Marcus Paulk. MARCUS.
Everything.
PAULK is the Instagram, MARCUSPAULK. This weekend, Sunday, we have the fashion show with Model Mafia, and it's being hosted by Nikki Baby from Love & Hip Hop Hollywood. It is going
She's
to be
cute.
At 650 South Spring Street at the Reserve, and it starts at 6 p.m. red carpet. We got a bunch of celebrities coming out. If you love fashion, you just love a good time, just come out and enjoy.
And you got tickets to give away.
But
what if somebody reaches you and say, I heard you on the rollout show.
So
I want to come.
If somebody wants to do that, I have two tickets to give away right now. If you hit me up on Instagram at Marcus Paulk, first person to do it, I'll give you two tickets.
It's so funny. I'm feeling my age right now because as I listen to you, I'm thinking I'm so proud of that baby. So I know.
I'm a grown man, baby.
But you could be my son.
No, I'm 29 years old.
You could be my son, baby. You could be my child. I could have pushed you
like that
out
youth.
Of here. Thank you. Now I'm even more proud. Like that. Thank you.
Thanks again for coming, man. And,
Thank you.
I called him at the most time you call people last minute. They're like, you give me next week.
Nah, you family. Yeah.
Hey, man, at the end of the day, you like my little son as well. I've been knowing you since.
It's like, woo.
You got more money than me. That's okay. You know,
well, everyone does.
Okay, shut up. You got $2 more than me. That's it.
Okay.
That's why I keep asking you for that same $2 so I can be
Bruno
up.
Money. You can reach me at Nikki Pam with 2 K's on. Our thing, and then also remember to buy a t-shirt. We got the bling ones in, and then I will send you a bottle or a little towel.
Yeah, you show them the bottle.
Hey. I don't know if you can see it because the lighting's kind of. But anyway, yeah.
Y'all fucked around.
Go to rolloutshow.com. It's in the store, and buy it.
Please.
These always make me feel like I need to have like a headband on, and a fanny pack,
right.
And like some short shorts
on.
Just be working out.
This
I want
bottle
a t-shirt.
Here. You want?
I want
oh,
a
we got the baby. Ooh.
That's what I want.
I'll give you a tank.
Thank you.
These bottles, if you drink a lot and you want to look like you actually just not drinking something, you put your Hennessy or
your
liquor
here.
Liquor there and sit.
Oh.
Man.
Nobody even knows.
Speedy is funny on everything. That's Speedy IZ funny on earth thing. Don't forget, please buy the t-shirts. They support the show. They keep us going. They keep the cast that we can put together here. They get our special guests here because all we got is snacks for them. Well, if Ron don't eat them. Ron go through that motherfucker. And he always act like he ain't going in. He got nine.
Ron, you
got to
make sure you play my song more, too.
Oh.
All right, that My Time Is Money.
Keep
that
running.
It's on iTunes, too, y'all. Y'all can buy it on iTunes. My Time Is Money, Marcus Paulk.
Buy the shit.
That's so good. Oh, the baby.
Speedy is funny on everything.
sorry.
Comedian Speedy on Facebook. I got some shows coming up. Go ahead.
Tangi Ambrose, heaven high. I'm Tangi Ambrose everywhere. Tangi Ambrose on Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, TangiAmbrose.com, HeavenHigh.com, Heaven High.
Do your kids have your
My
last
friend
name?
Sabrina knew
Nope.
She said, that's the Heaven High girl. She really did. My friend Sabrina. She used to work for BET.
Hey, Sabrina, girl!
Yep.
Sabrina.
Heaven High, Sabrina.
Yep, mm-hmm. She knew exactly.
She always listens to the show.
Oh, that's so sweet. The Heaven High girl. I like that.
Anyway. Go ahead, POTUS. Hilarious! She's getting work done.
You can follow me at OG Poetess on social media. And to check our lineup here at Morris Media Live, go to our website at morrismedialive.com. Please support the show. Yes. A lot of you guys have fallen off on the support, and we still need it.
Yes.
You can do that by donating to our PayPal at contact@morrismediastudios.com. And if you're interested in doing a podcast or internet radio show, you can email us at that same address at contact@morrismediastudios.com.
And if you can't donate, just get spread the word about the show. Let other people know to listen to us, and then our views will go up on that.
Yeah, retweet like them.
So you could do it that way as well. Shout out to my man, Mr. DJ Ron C. It's Ron, DJ Ron C7 on everything. If you want to get a mixtape from him, because as you can tell, his brother's the one.
Yeah,
and he does all his mixtapes in his sandals.
Yeah. He was playing a little bit of everything, man. I like that.
He was killing that shit.
Yeah. Shit.
And also, thanks to YZ who came through. He's actually doing an event he forgot to mention. Skate Jam at Fiesta Village is going on today from 5 to 10 p.m. And it is at 1405 East Washington Street in Colton, California.
It's off the 10, I think, right?
Yeah.
It supports Literacy Matters. So it's
say it again. What is it exactly?
The Summer Skate Jam going on at Fiesta Village in Colton, California at 1405 East Washington Street.
That's dope.
Okay. I know the skate.
And thanks for all our guests we had. YZ off the fucking chain.
Nikki Allen.
Please come back. Yeah, Nikki. Great, great clothing.
Gimmebody.com.
Amber can come back.
Yeah, before we go, I wanted to mention, since we didn't do the Poetess Report today, that Miss Cleo died.
Yeah,
I saw that.
Cleo.
53 years.
That's very old.
Young. That's younger than you. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I am not the barometer.
I was going to say a joke, but we shouldn't make that to the dead. I don't think. I almost had one.
Everybody says that.
But that's all when it.
But she caught a lot of flack. But she did start that early era.
How much money do you think she made off that?
Yeah, did she make a lot of money? Did they say Poetess in the article or anything?
They didn't say how much money, but the Psychic Readers Network did have a federal lawsuit filed against them back in the day for the company to forgive $500 million in customer fees.
Wow. Shit.
Because a lot of the people they had on there were not
real
psychics.
Not real psychics.
She's actually,
but how do they know who's a real psychic and who's not?
Hey, well, right. Depending on your paperwork. For those who don't know, she's actually from Seattle. My kid's mom went to her acting class.
She doesn't really talk like that.
She went to her acting class.
No, she was. They said she was born and raised in L.A.
But she was living in Seattle at the time.
This is Miss Cleo.
My kid's mom went to her acting class. That's how she knew her.
Everybody.
And she was like, why is everybody watching this? She's my acting coach back in Seattle.
Wow.
But yeah, she's born and raised here, moved to Seattle. Then the Jamaican accent was all.
So what it was considered like false advertisement, basically, just saying that you're psychic. And you're
But I remember
you're even Jamaican. That's the main part I'm upset about.
Yeah, exactly.
She sounded a little Irish when she used to do it.
Call
me now. The thing was, that commercial came on all
the time.
Especially during my soaps.
We all knew it.
Everybody knew who she was.
Because that was so popular, is because everybody is always looking for answers.
Yeah.
And they call these psychic hotlines. And
at that time, that was a hot thing. Did anyone here call?
Wonder what kind of rates she got.
No, because of those rates, I never would pick up the phone and call any of those numbers because I knew.
But she started it
all.
Was she a spokesperson? Well, yeah.
She started it as far as on TV. And us really, because psychics was people you went to, I'm going to just slip in this little back door.
I'm wondering, was it a psychic company that wanted to advertise? They had auditions. She came in with the accent and they hired her.
Probably
okay,
was.
So she didn't
start the network.
That's what I was
No, when I say she started, that's the first time I saw it on TV.
First time we knew what you could do.
Yeah,
the other
too.
Ones came
after
that.
There was a lot of copycats.
But she was the one I remember.
Call me now.
Anytime I picked the phone up, that motherfucker said, it would be $70.99 on your credit. No, nigga.
Yeah. Well, they said that she did publish a book called Keeping It Real, A Practical Guide for Spiritual Living. And she also was a voiced character in the 2002 Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, that's good.
Money. That's good money. That's good. People sleep.
But her reputation was tarnished by all that when they uncovered
that. Did they say what she died of?
She died of cancer. Okay. She's only 53.
She's 53 is young.
Yeah, very young.
I don't understand why her reputation was tarnished just because people believed that she was telling the truth.
Probably.
I guess they feel like she was a fraud with the fake Jamaican accent. And
yeah, maybe if she didn't have the accent, she could have got by. But yeah. now that the accent was fake, now I feel like I'm really being gypped here. Because you're winding me in thinking that you're an islander that may know something.
Right,
because
you assume they're from the earth.
Because when you're an islander, people believe they have more connection to that spirit.
I feel like... like Jamaicans and Rastafarians are some of the closest people who have it figured out. I mean, one love is the key in Jamaica. You know what I mean? And I think that we have so much separation between language and everything that's our biggest problem. We can't get on one vibration. Like, we worried about what we can do for us, but as a whole, if you have everybody that can't be on one accord, because you got fucked up people in every race.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And if people's mind aren't right, how do we all get on one accord? Like,
Pam.
You
know?
I'm still back because I'm still thinking, like, for example, if you want to sell, I don't know, you want to do some psychic stuff, and I come in and I audition and I'm so good that people believe me, she was acting.
But yeah, but at the time, people didn't know that.
Yeah.
But at the time,
they might have had a disclaimer on the commercial.
At the bottom.
I don't remember saying
that. I don't know.
She wouldn't have got hit for that bread if so.
Yeah, I mean, she wouldn't have got sued if so. Yeah.
Probably when you called, or you called back and said, that shit she told me was real.
She probably didn't even answer the phone. She was probably just
It probably said, call me now, not now.
Not here now.
But we got to get out of here. It's been a great fucking show. Tant, girl, you the shit.
Yay.
Yeah, she is.
You come back. Anytime you want.
I'd love to wear my little t-shirt.
Please.
Together.
Wear the one they gave you. That would be cool. It's been a great show. Again, make sure you donate. If you can't donate, tell somebody about the show. Maybe they'll donate. Buy a t-shirt. You get a bottle. You get some other stuff with it. So we're giving you stuff with the t-shirts. We have the bling and they have the ones without the bling. Please support. Please support. Thank you so very much. And it's been The Rollout. And DJ Ron. You know what he said. It's time to go. We can't stay.
Is this the...